Happy Thursday, everybody.
Yes.
Blazin It Radio, Larry Ulibarri, Kathie J. Wiggins. By the way, happy hour tonight at Alamo Draft House.
Yes.
Sloan's Lake from 4 to 6. Come down and hang out with us. Try the Blazin It Radio drink. It's delicious, but it's kind of hot.
Hot. That's why I say only go with one muddled jalapeno
drink.
Right, but that sure does clean out your sinuses.
Well, you think about, like, Kim Jong-un, you know, tested a new thing, and, you know, Trump's trying to clap back, so it's kind of stressful.
Yes.
And then you turn the channel, and it's like, Matt Lauer did what?
Oh, yeah.
Just like, wow. Everything's falling apart. So we just wanted a little window of happiness for happy hour.
Exactly. Let's all just hang out and drink and enjoy some appetizers and laugh. Laugh like we've never laughed before.
Let's get together with a bunch of listeners and expose our genitals.
No.
Okay, what is with guys that are doing that, like, well, you know, we've established that rich, successful white guys really like to perv out.
Right. But use it as control.
Right. So, but when you, like, just whip it out, that's pretty ballsy.
Ayo. Yeah, and you know what? We barely like looking at our husbands.
That's exactly what I was going to say.
So why am I going to want to look at a stranger?
Thank you. Girls don't like it like that.
But if the strangers comes with a promotion, a lot of girls might take it up.
Right, or maybe because it's a famous guy. Uh-huh. You know what I mean?
True.
So and then Kathy...
There's girls that would have been more than happy to sleep with Matt Lauer.
No. So for every girl that gasped and ran away, there was probably 10 that were like, all right, Mr. Lauer.
Right, you don't know.
Right.
So, but they said that there's 3 so far.
Well, and then there's all these videos surfacing of, like, Katie Couric saying that he grabbed her ass all the time.
He pinched her butt a lot.
Did you hear about Meredith how he Vera. Locked the door? Did
yeah,
you hear that?
From his desk.
So he had, like, a 007 secret button. Kind of like Burns. When Burns was mad at someone, the hole in the floor would happen. But he would just lock the door, and then he'd get trapped in there.
He'd hit a button, the door would lock, and his pants would fall down.
Probably, yeah.
It goes at the same time.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And then I guess the one girl, he reprimanded her when she was like, I'm not going to perform on you. And he reprimanded her, and she didn't work at NBC.
Whoa. Like, reprimanded as in, you're going to get a spanking for not doing that.
Again, no.
No, thank you.
A guy would try one more time. Spanking?
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Yeah, so it always starts, these stories usually start with, like, one incident.
Yeah.
And then you're like, oh, maybe it was just one incident.
So they had heard about the other incidents, there are two incidents, the NBC, and apparently even anchors knew that there were rumors. Everybody knew there was a rumor, but nobody wanted to admit that their friend.
No, right, because everybody
loved him there, like Meredith Vieira.
And whatever happened Monday night, with the girl that came in Monday night that went to HR, she had enough detailed information, and it was so graphic to the point where they went, we're not dealing with this.
Right.
We fired Matt.
Right.
So it wasn't the Vanity Fair article that was coming out that forced him to...
No, the Vanity Fair, because that's who I was listening to this morning. They were already starting to dig, and the girl went on her own. They didn't even know her name. They didn't even know she existed. She went on her own Monday night. So she might have heard that there was digging, so she thought it was a good time to just go do it, say it. But it wasn't them finding her.
Or
she did it herself.
Or she realized the girl who comes out first gets the biggest chunk of settlement. Usually, sometimes, you know what I mean?
Yeah. But I said something yesterday. Remember, I was like... You kept saying, where in the world
is Matt Lauer?
And I was like, you know, think about that. He used to do those world trips.
Oh, for sure.
For the show. And along with that, there goes interns, there goes production assistants. And that's who it was. It was a young intern at the Olympics.
Said in, the Olympics was the biggest one where he was just going crazy. It must have been like his Olympics of sexual
and then
harassment.
He thinks, I'm out of the country. I can be horny here.
Yeah. Right.
The thing
an intern, you knew that was that's young.
Yeah, if you start any business or if you're in charge and you're running and you're in charge of successful people like him or like, you know, Fox News people or whatever,
right?
You're like, we're only hiring guy interns. You know what I mean? So they won't have any issues.
No,
you know?
But still, they still wouldn't survive. Yeah. And then all of a sudden, it's the old school Greek apprentice thing.
Oh, yes.
I'm kidding.
Yeah,
kidding.
No, or just, you know,
I'd like to show you how to
right.
strap my sandals. Oh,
yes. When a man chucks a spear.
Larry, you're going to freak out. Look at all the Nissan Star Wars trucks that they have at the LA Auto Show.
Oh, those are sick.
That's cool.
Oh, dude, we got to show you those. They're all decked out with armor and lighting, and they just have the guns on them.
I know, like, it's a big deal for Nissan. Yeah.
I knew having a TV in here would be a problem.
Oh, man.
You totally just got distracted.
Oh, dude, you do the Star. It was the Star Wars thing.
I know, but we're like middle mid sentence topic, whatever. Bouncing ball goes by. Right. Look, a red ball went by.
Squirrel.
But it looked like a Star Wars. Ball,
I know.
Though.
That's when you save it in the back of your head and go, "Hey, we should bring up those Star Wars trucks later."
They do look sick. There's, I saw a bunch of them when I was at Larry Miller Nissan over the weekend.
Yeah, yeah, and it's funny because they did such a huge deal with them for the Rogue, and it was such a huge success that Star Wars stuck with Nissan for this movie.
Yes, Last Jedi.
Yeah, but there's no. The Rogue was a one-off. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? So there's no way.
The movie title was
right,
a one-off,
right.
Yeah.
So they couldn't really like.
Right.
Have you know
the Nissan
TIE
Tauntaun.
Fighter?
Right.
Yeah, yeah. Still works though.
Right.
The Tauntaun's a lot cheaper than the TIE Fighter.
Nobble, 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 nobble. Right, and you have to feed them.
Speaking of Star Wars, Larry, did you RSVP?
Yes, I did.
Okay, good. To the email.
Yes.
Okay.
And so yeah, we'll be seeing that.
You get one date.
Right.
Yeah. Who's that going to be?
My boo.
Oh, I thought you were going to take Wiggins.
Oh, no.
No, I'm good.
That's my ex-boo. Yeah.
Okay. You don't care about Star Wars, Wade?
I do, but I don't have time. So I'll see it when it comes to...
Ain't nobody got time for
see,
that.
See, that's what happened with Star Wars with the one where... I think it was the Rogue one with Han Solo. Was that the one with Han Solo? The one with Han Solo was the one I didn't see until it was, like, out
Maybe
on...
Maybe that is Rogue, yeah.
On digital download.
That was the...
The Awakening.
Right.
Yeah.
Force Awakens.
Yeah. So I didn't see that, and that was when Larry... ruined that Han died. So anytime that someone would talk about Star Wars, I'd be like, la 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 la.
Right.
I'd put my fingers in my ears and then...
right here.
Yeah, and then it was either Larry or I think it was like a Facebook meme that went viral where someone put on the back of their Jeep, Han Solo dies. And I was all, no!
Right. But no, Larry did the spoiler thing as well.
Yeah, but it had been out for a really long time, and you wait forever, and we
like
can't wait forever.
No,
I waited
until
the download.
I did not say
no
that
way.
2 weeks after that.
I waited until the download to see it, so it'd probably a long time.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'm excited for that. Isn't that on your husband? Isn't that Chris's birthday that it comes out December 15th?
December 15th.
Yes, and we already bought tickets, you know, because we knew we wanted to see it. So right. I'll be seeing it twice.
So is the other showing like during the day, or did you have to get like a midnight showing?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh,
I have no idea. He bought Chris bought them. So.
Oh, okay. See, I've never bought tickets in advance like that for a movie. It's probably a good thing.
That's the best way to go now because now you can actually see what seats are available. So when we were looking to go see Coco with Avery, we were like, oh, there's only front row left.
Yeah, not doing that.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, that is the worst. I said it front row for Daddy's Home 2, which was pretty funny.
Is it funny?
It's really
funny.
How
was Mel Gibson?
He's a jerk in the movie,
but
so it's like him playing himself.
Right.
Yeah. But so when you sit in the front row, like your neck is going like back and forth,
it
like trying to watch the whole screen. It kills you.
So that is with John Lithgow and Mel Gibson?
Yes.
And Mark Wahlberg and Will Ferrell.
That just doesn't seem like you'll go see that, but not Star Wars.
Yeah, well, that was because the first one, Kayla and I really liked, and then we were just like, well, let's go see
a movie.
And, right. then that came out. And
it
that
wasn't
was really,
as hilarious?
This one was actually a little bit funnier. It's like a stupid comedy. Like, things happen where you're like, okay, that's dumb, right. But it's still super
Like, the tree
funny.
Fell on him.
Yeah, well, he cut the satellite tower down.
Right.
And he got electrocuted. So it's just funny. I never saw the... Will Ferrell, Amy, Polar one where they were in
House,
the
gamblers.
Right.
Yeah,
did it was
you see
a good
that?
One.
Was it good?
It was really good.
Do you trust Rotten Tomatoes?
I don't know how that works because is it the higher percentage of tomatoes that makes it like a great movie?
A good movie.
Okay,
yes.
So
it's not a razzle or whatever they call those. This
okay,
is,
so right. The tomatoes represent people throwing tomatoes at it.
No.
Rotten Tomatoes?
If you get a low rating. Like, if you're 2% approval, that's Rotten Tomatoes.
Okay.
And then the other one is, like, fresh, red, organic tomatoes if you get 100% on it.
But the thing is, Rotten Tomatoes, though, it goes off of when critics go in and rate the movie.
Okay.
So if you have a movie that critics haven't gone in and rated yet because it just came out or something like that, technically you got 100% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Oh, okay.
You know, like it goes down the more people talk and say, I hated this.
Well, and then there's some movies that are just so good, it just has like a high rating because everybody knows that movie was great.
Right. But like Rotten Tomatoes said, didn't like Justice League, but I did.
Okay.
You know, so sometimes mm-hmm. they are off.
Did you see Lady Bird? Have you seen that?
It has I heard it's great.
Has Jackie from Roseanne in it, and it had the highest Rotten Tomato rating in the history of their site.
Wow.
It had everyone who watched
She's a Lady Bird?
Lady Bird.
Everyone who watched it loved
it? Gave it 100%.
Chris Parente said it was one of his favorite films of the year.
I think it's like an Oscar-type series.
So Lady Bird Johnson? Like, she's the president's...
No, that's what I thought, too. But
she's a bird lady.
It has nothing to do with...
It's a daughter-mother relationship. Yeah. It's
has nothing to do with birds, and it has nothing to do with...
Well, I don't like it then.
I want to hear
something. I'm a bird lady.
Lady Bird.
Right.
Pretty Lady Bird.
Oh, my God.
That movie's foul.
Yeah.
So we've been getting a bunch of letters in, man. Every morning I wake up and I just see people that must be getting home and writing us the Christmas wish
letters.
Good.
I'm ready to read them. Print them.
Yeah. So.
Yep. Send your letter on behalf of somebody else to Christmas wish at blazinitradio.com and nominate somebody. Send us a little bit about them as far as what they might need to get through the holiday.
Yeah. So that's been exciting. And then I'm throwing up the website for that. We're starting a GoFundMe, so we're going to be, and everyone gets involved with that for the Christmas wish, so I'm really excited for that, because people who always want to listen, to how can I help out? Like, that's going to be so awesome.
Right.
Yeah, this will be the easiest way, rather than you sending us gift cards and stuff. Just put the money in the GoFundMe, we'll go get it. But you'll be able to see everything we're doing. Mm-hmm.
Right.
The GoFundMe's transparent.
Right, and it's like, it's also, you know, we save some money and put money aside for the wishes that just involve toys and kids.
Yep.
Yes.
And so that's really exciting to see if you gave to the GoFundMe and then you get to watch later what kid got the toy that you gave. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, that's
or
so cool.
Or you helped us get.
Right.
It really makes you tear up, though. That year we did at the hotel where the kids picked it out.
That was awesome.
Oh, my God. It's hard. Even the Christmas wish. This is the first time I'm going to act. Because I'd walk out of the room when you guys did Christmas wish years before because it was so emotional.
This year
I'm going to be like bawling like a little baby. Like,
yeah, it's hard because somebody has to edit those into, you know, like smaller pieces.
That was you.
Yeah. And so I normally just sit in a darkened production room and hope nobody comes in. And then if somebody comes in, I'm all, hey, what's up? How's it going?
I know you
look down. How's it going?
Yeah, no big deal.
Please leave.
Dusty in here, huh?
Right.
We got to get some people in here working. Allergies.
Killing me. 303-728-3420. You can call us in the app, the Android app. Hopefully the update is out today. If not, let me know, and I'll give you the link so you can get the beta test. But people have been sending us shout-outs, so we're going to play those shout-outs here in a little bit. And otherwise, just give us a call or a text.
From the Mile High City.
And now, worldwide.
You're streaming Larry and Kathy's Blazin' Hit Radio.
Blazin' Hit Radio, Larry Ulibarri, Kathy J, and Wiggins. Happy Thursday. Tomorrow's Friday.
Oh, yeah.
That was half Kathy, half Frank. So basically, we'd really like you to stop by, you know, for a happy hour.
Yes.
And get so wasted that you miss work tomorrow.
No, because we don't get to miss work tomorrow. I don't want to know that I help somebody else enjoy their day off.
4 to 6, Alamo Draft House, Sloan's Lake. So
we were talking about the Matt Lauer thing earlier, right, and all that went down. And so I there's the audio. Did you guys see when his co-host actually talked about the incident and Matt Lauer being removed from the job? Okay, so check this out.
And good morning, everybody. Welcome to Today. And Hoda's here with me at this morning because this is a sad morning here at Today and at NBC News. Just moments ago, NBC News Chairman Andy Lack sent the following note to our organization. Dear colleagues, on Monday night, we received a detailed complaint from a colleague about inappropriate sexual behavior in the workplace by Matt Lauer. It represented, after serious review, a clear violation of our company's standards. As a result, we have decided to terminate his employment. While it is the first complaint about his behavior in the over 20 years he has been at NBC News, we were also presented with reason to believe this may not have been an isolated incident. Our highest priority is to create a workplace environment where everyone feels safe and protected.
So it wasn't a one-off. It wasn't one incident.
No. That's her announcement yesterday.
Yeah, right. Her announcement yesterday. Yeah.
So that means that like he was a repeat offender as far as showing his junk, or
from what I heard from someone that's, you know, because I told you, New York press, they'll find out what it was and right. give us detail. It's three women so far.
Oh, okay. And was it like, I'm pushing myself on you, or was it look at my goodies?
One was the girl, was the intern that went to the Olympics with him.
Okay.
The other one that broke the camel's back, the straw that broke the camel's back, was uh-huh. Monday night.
Okay.
And
oh, so it was super recent.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So he didn't, you would think that somebody in his business of being around all this, that he would have been like, well, I better back off the
well,
show on my
it's
jump.
It's even like I have tons of audio. Like there's audio where they do a weird thing where Matt Lauer talks about his underwear to people on air. So it's like
it all sounds different now.
Yeah, it sounds totally different now. Right.
And to ensure that any actions that run counter to our core values are met with consequences, no matter who the offender. We are deeply saddened by this turn of events, but we will face it together as a news organization and do it in as transparent a manner as we can.
So is he married?
Yeah, he's got a wife.
Been married for like 20 years or something like that.
She's beautiful. Three kids. She's an ex-model.
Right. So she's probably at home in their giant mansion not knowing?
No. Well, in 2006, she filed for divorce, and she wrote on the reasoning. It was something like...
he likes to show stuff.
No, like he mentally was an angry person at home.
Oh.
Something like that. And she just didn't want to... She couldn't deal with it.
He seems so happy on TV.
He does, but that's what
that is the statement from our chairman, Andy Lack. And we just learned this moments ago, just this morning. As I'm sure you can imagine, we are devastated and we are still processing all of this. And I will tell you right now, we do not know more than what I just shared with you. But we will be covering this story as reporters, as journalists. I'm sure we will be learning more details in the hours and days to come. And we promise we will share that with you.
Mm-hmm. Now she sounded upset, like he never touched me. What's wrong with me?
Well, no. A lot of people that worked there. I was here listening to one of the people that wrote the Variety article, mm-hmm. and they were saying there was the Matt you see in public, and then the Matt behind the scenes, and then a lot of his coworkers, past and present, knew about Matt and some of his
off-colored
comments and stuff. Okay. Like he had a button at his desk that he'd put and that he'd hit and it would shut the door.
Whoa.
Right.
That's so quagmire.
Right.
Giggity, giggity. All right.
And the one girl said that once that happened, then he dropped his pants and expected her to, and she said no, and then she got reprimanded for it.
So was the door like, would it lock so the girl couldn't get out?
Yeah, lock the office door.
Whoa.
That's kind of crazy.
Well, so Katie Couric was with Andy Cohen a while back, and someone found a clip where they said, what is the worst habit or trait about Matt Lauer?
You co-hosted the Today Show with Matt Lauer for 15 years. What is Matt's most annoying habit?
He pinches me on the ass a lot.
Wow! I wouldn't have a problem with that. Thanks, everybody.
That's insane that he would do that to somebody like her because she seems like so, like, I've interviewed presidents.
I totally agree.
Dignitaries.
There's a line of where it's tee-hee ha-ha.
Right.
You know, like, to Katie, obviously, she didn't.
They got along.
Right, and then the Meredith Vieira clip where she's bending over, grabbing something, and the mics were...
Oh, right,
and
they weren't like, filming, keep and bending over.
That's a nice view.
Right.
Like, you know, Meredith says that she loves Matt.
They're besties.
Like, that wasn't, to her, harassment.
Right,
well... Because they were on a different level.
Probably because sometimes you make friends with somebody you have no intention of sleeping with.
Right.
So he could make female friends, and like they could be like, oh, I trust him, he's around my kids, and blah, 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 we're like friends.
Right.
So, but if you were... hot intern, he could care less.
Right. They also say that he would always do the Mary Blank kill game. Okay.
And put himself in it?
No. with the females that work there at NBC.
Oh, okay.
You know, but a lot of us have
done that,
but you do that privately with people you trust.
Let's do it. Here we go. I trust you guys.
Okay.
All right, so Mary Blank kill.
Yes.
Dutra, Yonke, and
if you do all guys, come on, don't do all guys.
This is for her.
Oh, this is for her. Okay.
No, this is for Larry.
No, this is for you.
Well, I'm sure you have your answer you want to share with us.
And that guy that wears the hat.
Dan Drew.
Yeah, Dan Drew, Greg Dutra, and Kirk Yonke.
I don't know.
You shouldn't say anything because you work there.
Right.
Yeah, Larry's like putting you on the spot.
Right.
No, we heard what you said this morning.
We know you killed the guy in the hat. Let's just get that out of the way.
Maybe she'd hook up with him. You don't know.
Kathy has a sordid past with TV personalities.
Just one. We never did anything.
Yeah,
we never even held hands.
It was a reporter, and Kathy dipped out during the date.
I did. I had to call Larry's husband, Christopher. and say, come get me, please. Just pretend like you're coming in. And because I didn't have a car.
At the time. So he picked her up or whatever.
I had loaned my car to an idiot. And so I didn't have a car. So thank God Chris came and he walked in. I was like, Chris, what are you doing here? And he was like, nothing. I'm coming to meet some friends for a drink. And he was like, oh, I don't think they're here anymore. And I was like, oh, can I catch a ride? I'm going to leave. Bye.
And that reporter doesn't know that, does he?
Oh, no, he does. We talked about it
on the air.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
He's fine. It's been a while.
Oh, no, yeah. He's totally fine.
Right.
And it's Greg Nieto. And he has from Fox 31.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I was thinking it was Ken Clark.
No. Okay. No, Ken and I went to college together.
Right. Oh, okay. Right. That's why I thought it was him. I was okay.
We were part of a comedy troupe in college. Ken and I have definitely had sexual harassment against each other.
I've known Kathy for so long.
Harassment, everyone.
That she, when Ken came down here one time to hang out with Chris and I and her.
Right. I was like, you got to come meet Larry Uleberry. He's so nice. And it was right when we were getting out of college, trying to get in the business.
Right. So Kathy had this stack of pictures of Ken, and we were like looking through the pictures. And so just before he got to my house, I proceeded to put his pictures in all the frames. And I even hung him on the fridge.
It
so
was
he
hilarious.
Came in and he started hanging out and just talking and we're having drinks. And then he looks over Kathy's shoulder and he looks, squints, and he's like, why is that a picture of me? And then he doesn't say anything. And then he turns around and he looks the other way and there's
and
another picture
of him on the mantle.
Right, exactly. He's like, what's happening here?
And then we send him to the fridge, go get us some,
beer.
And he goes over and he's like, four pictures. What's happening? Going on? You do things like that that I would never think about, but they are so funny. Yeah. Like, I'm so, like,
love Ken.
Ever since Larry came in my life, I've been laughing.
We make each other pee sometimes.
Yeah, that's true. Especially when I was pregnant, I had no bladder control.
There was a girl that I grew up with at Heritage Square. Uh-huh. There was two girls vying for my affections. One girl was named Tara, her dad owned the candy store, and the other girl was Fat Nancy.
Oh, yeah.
And Fat Nancy's parents on the paint by numbers kind of thing.
Okay, you think Tara would be Fat Tara if her parents owned the candy store?
No, she was skinny.
Okay, skinny Tara and Fat Nancy.
Fat Nancy.
You went skinny Tara, right?
Well, no, whatever. I hang out with both of them. But I used to make Nancy laugh so hard she'd pee. And she'd be like so mad. And in the winter, it was fine. She'd just fall in the snow and pee. And then it just looked like she got wet from the snow.
It's a regular thing?
Yeah, but if it was like during the regular time, she'd just sit on a bench and pee. And I made her laugh so hard. And
she would really pee.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't just a tinkle that came out.
I'm funny. So I was funny even then.
He's been practicing his craft since day
one. I've been owning it ever since. And I'm like, that's a win. When I make that girl pee, I know I was funny.
Or maybe she has like a bladder condition. That's
little
so
did you know
odd.
She had a horrible UTI problem.
I don't know. I just, it always came when I had the best joke.
If so you've ever peed your pants because of Larry, call
whatever.
Us now.
No, that's true. A lot of people should call that. We have.
Tara, the other girl, she was the one that was like sexually mature.
What does that mean?
Like, in other words, she was very aggressive, and she was the one that's like
wanting some,
right? But not like all the way some, but just to do weird things. And she'd be like, oh, let me sit on your lap and tell you what I want for Christmas.
Okay,
and I'd be like, okay.
That?
And she'd be like all, like not sitting still. She'd be kind of like writhing. And so I'd be like, okay, let's not play this anymore. Yeah, I'd be like, what?
Ho, ho,
right,
you're a ho.
Right, exactly. So then I'd be like, well, what else can we play? And she's like, let's play Easter Bunny. And I was like, okay. And she's like, you're the Easter Bunny. And then she sat on my lap. And she's like,
somebody had daddy issues.
Right, exactly. No, for real.
Let me sit on your lap.
Yeah,
that's how we do it in my house.
And if you saw her dad, you'd be like, something's weird about that candy maker.
Okay.
So I wasn't 100% sure on that.
Right.
But it's like, I didn't want to ruin that relationship because every time I went in to see her, her mom would give me a piece of candy. So, hey, what's up? It's Tara here. And she's like, yeah, hold on. You want something? I'd be like, oh.
Okay, like
I
guess. Stupid ribbon candy candy?
Handmade chocolates.
Like, here's some fudge or something.
No, handmade chocolates.
Yum.
Like, it was all handmade. It was amazing in there.
So you'd grab the candy and then leave.
Right, and then I'd go make Nancy pee.
Yeah.
Wow, it was a tough day at work for you, Larry.
Gosh.
Did you ever work?
Yes, I did. I worked at the Weenie Wagons.
Of course you did. That was your best job.
I got two weenies here.
You know that meme of the woman getting hit in the face with a bunch of wieners, slow motion?
No.
You haven't seen that meme?
No.
And it's like somebody throwing like 10 hot dogs at this woman in the face and it all hits her in the face. Okay. That was me.
Is that where you learn the
dangle the hot dog in front of your face?
I don't know. There was lots of jokes going on there, lots of comedy.
I'm sure there were. A lot of things you would have been charged with sexual harassment if it was today.
No, because I was definitely, at that point in my life, I was the one that was victimized by Tara. Okay.
Right. But you'd give, hey, Nancy, I got you two wieners.
Hey, Nancy.
Because you're fat, I knew you'd eat both of them.
Is that hot dog water, or are you just laughing?
So no one's going to come out and be like, I worked with Larry years ago at the Weenie Wagon. And
No. Like, the thing is, I was, like, the kid there, and so everybody really liked me. Everybody, like, looked out for me.
Of course they did.
But they, like, looked out for me like I was their brother, you know, like the little kid brother.
Yeah.
So everybody was super nice to me growing up, and, you know, I was, like, obviously gay inside, but I didn't, you know, I know, but I just knew that when the guys that worked there were nice to me, I was just like, oh.
For some reason, like, I like this more.
Right, and I was like, this guy, Carl, was like, he was just one of the hottest guys there, and
hey,
was like,
hey, Larry, I'm Carl. That kind of a Carl?
I don't know, he was just, hey, what's up, I'm Carl.
Okay, see, there's two different guys, Carls.
And he would operate, you know those things you used to get in, they still have them, like, at certain places where everybody sits in, and there's a screen, and then it looks like you're taking off, and then, you know, it goes left, and it goes right. So there's
a ride?
Yeah, and okay. It's like you get in, and it's a tube, and there's a screen. It looks like you're
like Dave and Buster's.
Kind of, yeah. So he would operate that, and then one time he was like, hey, little buddy, he's like, you want to sit up here with me and operate it? And he was like, just wearing shorts and no shirt. And I was like, yes, sure. And so I just sat there on his lap while he was operating it. I was like, this is definitely my calling.
Oh, yes. Larry all of a sudden was like a girl sitting in front of a guy with his arms wrapped around her like they're on a motorcycle.
Right, for sure.
Going down the open road. Who knows what's going to lay ahead in your future.
He didn't know.
Feeling his skin against you.
Everybody comes to their sexual awakening whenever.
At some point. So the new app allows the shout-out feature, and so a lot of people have been, you literally can go into the menu bar, hit the shout-out, send us a message, it comes straight to us and we get it. So we actually have a few of those that came in when the show was off yesterday during the replay. So here, this one is more of a self-promotion, but it still works.
Hi, my name is Mikwadza B. Zuman of the Slaughterhouse Derby Girls in Greeley, Colorado.
Yeah.
I listen to Larry, Kathie, and Wiggins on Blazin Hit Radio.
Oh.
You can check out Slaughterhouse Derby Girls at the website, slaughterhousederbygirls.com.
Wow, she's a professional. Yeah. She gave us a drop. That's called a drop.
Good PR for the Slaughterhouse Derby Girls.
In Greeley. She knew exactly what she was doing. I'll give them some love, and then I'm going to drop the bomb.
Get it, girl.
Here's another one.
Hey, I listen to you guys all the time. You're awesome. I just wanted to ask a question. What's the deal with Wiggins and Larry? Are you guys like really a couple, or didn't you guys date or live together? What's going on with that?
Give me a break. Say biscuitos. Say biscuitos. That was the white dude. Totally that's Larry. You, yeah. Larry.
Whoever that guy was sounds handsome. And to answer your question,
that's
sir,
the white dude that you
Wiggins
were
and I did used to live together, but that was strictly platonic. As you know, he's a breeder and I'm not.
Yeah. No, it was an intern thing. I was an intern. I was not going to be
able
to.
That doesn't sound good.
He's like,
it was an intern thing. He said I had to do stuff for rent.
I wasn't going to be able to live. Yeah, all right. We're going to move on.
He was.
It was platonic.
Larry finally said, nothing happened. Yeah. You just left it there.
Listen,
it was an intern. I have no money. I was hungry.
I was down on my luck. I wanted a bowl of soup. I'd do anything. I'd do anything for a nice warm bed. No, it was more of a, you know, I saw everything that he was bringing to the show, and I was like, we can't lose this guy,
right.
And he wasn't making any dough, so I was like, well, I can offer you free place to live until you start getting paid, and so that was that.
And that went on for 10 years. No,
oh, yes.
Yeah, how long did you stay there?
Like 6 months, because I couldn't take the pop music and all that stuff.
I'd be like, in the morning, I'd be like, hey, let's go to work, ready, buddy? And then we'd get in the car, and he'd be like, I did it again. And then he'd be like, can you please turn that off? And I'd be like, he wants to talk. So I'm like, turn these down.
No, he doesn't
like What's
to talk
up, buddy?
Either.
Let's talk.
He doesn't like to talk either.
Hey, guys. Funny and great job as always. Hey, Larry, what about the stalker Chicano guy?
The what? For the stalker Chicano guy for DIA.
Oh, yeah. That guy like this.
Yeah.
Welcome to Denver. It's all cold today. Hope you brought a sweater. Welcome to DIA. My name's Larry, and that's Kathie.
Hi.
Hey.
Oh, okay. Oh, so no, I guess we're wrapping up.
The train is coming. Watch out.
Did you guys send that off? You recorded
it. We're sending it this morning.
Oh, because it's due today.
It is. Yeah.
You guys are turning in the homework late.
Well, and here's what we did.
Were those people?
It was right on time. I mean, you know, we hit the deadline, but we did our take on the, you know, announcements at DIA.
Yeah.
And so we did like a straight read each.
Mm-hmm. A normal read, learning Kathy's voice as or did you do an announcer voice?
I kind of did announcer.
I think it was you. No, I think you did your voice.
Half you, half announcer.
Well, I mean, when I did my solo,
yeah.
I kind of did a. Train is coming.
Yeah, that's good.
Right.
Because they need both your voices.
Right. And then we did a couple takes where it was just Kathy and I having fun.
Right.
She was like, the white zone is for passenger pickup. And I was all, the red zone is for unloading only.
The yellow zone is for a 2-minute wait.
Janice, you know this isn't about the yellow zone. It's about your abortion.
Oh my goodness, God, Hal. Welcome to Denver.
I don't know if we're going to get the gig.
Yeah, I don't know. You never know. So, all right, and then one more shout out down here. And then anytime you can send us that this morning.
Hello, this is Father Abercrombie. Oh. I heard you mention me on your radio show. So nice to hear you guys are back. Wiggins would love to get to you and talk about being reared in the rectory.
All right.
And, when's the last time that happened for you, young man?
Oh, thank you, Father Abercrombie.
When did you last get reared in the rectory?
Never happened, Larry.
Oh. Okay,
never happened.
So, Larry, you called in twice for the show.
I was testing out the feature.
Both of them were related to something gay.
Yeah. I was testing out the feature because I was that's really cool.
Did you catch that?
Uh-huh. Yeah. And I was pretty excited about the feature because I was like, wow, you can record it and then listen to it to make sure you did a good take.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. And we're testing it, just for our listeners. For sure. Like that.
Yeah, but we want to hear from you too. So download the app and then hit the shout out button and hook us up.
Once again, that's Slaughterhouse Derby Girls in Greeley.
Yep.
Larry and Kathy J's Blazin' Hit Radio.
It's Blazin'.
Roll the fatty up. Where's my lighter? Yeah. Just wrote the last of my medicine. Went to the clinic, said let me in. I'm out of bud.
I'm out of bud. Bud.
I'm out of bud, bud, bud. Looking through my car for a little roach. Just scraped the bottom of my glass bowl. I'm out of bud.
I'm out of bud. Bud. Bud.
Out of bud. 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 See, I know I'm addicted. I smell like a skunk. But I'd rather be this than a typical drunk. Not into meth, don't sip syrup. I like more of an herbal cure. Sure, I have a dependency, but I love being able to walk in a dispensary. Who cares if I'm paranoid about everything?
Everything, everything.
I know some people think I'm terrible, but I say nug makes you bearable. I'm out of bud.
Out of bud.
Out of bud. Can someone please run me a sack? I'm about to have a panic attack. I'm out of bud.
I'm out of bud.
I'm out of bud.
Is there anything worse?
No, no, no.
Yeah.
No, there's nothing worse.
Nobody really has to worry about that as much anymore.
When we're in Colorado.
It's
when you go visit relatives for Christmas that you're screwed.
So Saturday, December 9th, the Green Solution ribbon cutting is going down at the Kentucky Avenue in Glendale location. Kathy J is going to be there from 1 to 3 cutting it, and there's going to be tons of prizes. And there's always food and all these things going on down there. So make sure
I'll be there, too.
Yeah, Larry's
no, Larry's going to be a Larry Miller Nissan that
no,
day.
No, she's at Larry
I'm
Miller
at Larry Miller Nissan.
Well, then, I got the paperwork wrong, and Aldo doesn't. No, know what he's writing in here.
Right. I'll be at Larry Miller Nissan from 11 to 1. Larry's going to be there at 1 to 3 at the Kentucky location for the Green Solution. I'll come and meet you.
Join us.
As soon as I'm done.
For sure.
So you will be there for the ribbon cutting.
Yes.
Okay, well then that's why that says that.
Okay. Okay. All right. So Aldo didn't get it wrong.
Yeah, no, it says...
You read it
no,
wrong.
It says Kathie J will be there for the ribbon cutting.
Yeah, sure.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
But then it says Larry's at Larry Miller.
Oh, no, that was wrong.
Either way, the ribbon cutting's happening for the Green Solution in Glendale at Kentucky Avenue, so go check that out. So that way you're not out of bud.
Exactly.
Another location. They are killing it.
Oh, man, I can't... The one that's supposed to open up right next to us, I can't wait for that one. Was Alpha 20th? It's kind of by the Union...
WWATA,
that's what it is.
I was over there. It's like 19th and WWATA. From the outside, it looks ready to go. But that whole area is crazy with construction. Like, there didn't used to be a road back there.
Yeah,
so
I know.
To think that there's not just a road, there are high-rise buildings. There's a huge Whole Foods.
Yeah.
There's one of my favorite restaurants, that Tupelo Honey.
So good.
I wanted you to go, but remember, you stopped eating meat. As soon as I went and did the restaurant review, I was like, Larry, I found heaven. They have the best fried chicken I've ever had, the best mac and cheese, and you were like, I'm not eating meat anymore.
Or dairy.
Right. So I was like, well.
Well, I still eat meat.
Right, right.
I eat dairy.
You and I can go vegan. Yeah. They have frosé all day, Larry. You could drink that.
You know, I
frosé, what's that?
Frosé. It's like it's frozen rosé.
Oh, it's like a frozen wine.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, and it's bomb. Okay. They go fast, I tell you.
Right. So wait a minute. Where's that at? That's in Lodo? I mean.
It's like 17th and WWATA.
Okay.
So the Green Solution location that we're dying to open is right off of 19th and WWATA.
It'll be so close. Because right now we go to the Edgewater, but it's not too far.
It's not too far.
Yeah. In fact, that's even closer to where our happy hour is going to be on Colfax and Sheridan at the Alamo Draft House tonight.
Tonight, everybody. Come and drink with us.
Come hang out with us.
So we're about to hit December. And the weather's kind of been really nice.
Yeah,
it's so weird. My grass.
Totally weird.
My grass still thinks it's alive.
Right, exactly. And by now it should just be brown.
Right.
But looks like the snow's going to come on Monday, bringing 40 degree temperatures, and we might stay there for a while in December.
There's a lot of people that are like, I've been dying for some snow.
Me too. I've been dying for some colder weather. I keep dressing like it's cold outside, and, you know, with the boots, and, you know, I love all these sweaters, and I'm baking.
But the cold weather has effects on us.
It does. 5 weird things the cold weather can do to your body. Okay. We know one.
Makes your nipples hard.
Oh.
Oh, was that
I was
it?
Going for the guy joke. There's that joke.
Oh, shrinkage.
But, right. I was going for shrinkage. That's right. Not on the list, though.
Okay.
But that's what I immediately think when I think about
yeah, especially when
guys
you see,
in cold weather.
When you see those guys that like jump out of the hot tub and they go roll in the snow, or those guys that actually go out to a lake and jump in it.
How do they do that?
Right.
Right. Oof. Yeah, you think your junk would be like, I.
That's how you get your transgender assignment surgery.
Oh, is that how you do
it? Yeah, you jump in and immediately it's an innie.
It jumps up. Okay, so here's some things that happen to your body. It's going to start happening next week since we'll be in the 40s during the day. You burn more calories. That's good for all of us because I don't know about you, but in the winter, I definitely eat more.
Right. Well, I mean, you got to pack on that, you know, weight for, you know,
hibernation. I mean, the blubber I've been carrying around for 20 years.
Oh, yes.
I could always use more, right? It's winter.
Right.
Plus, shut my up. Sweaters are so big and roomy.
You know, thicker people, we can't layer like you thinner people.
I know. I do hate it when I see somebody that can tuck a sweater in. What is wrong with you?
Like,
you're not even human.
Like Ryan Seacrest, he's like, I wore a shirt, a vest, a jacket, a sweater,
right.
Another jacket,
right.
And I still look skinny.
I know.
Whatever, bitch.
Just once I want a layer.
Right.
Just once.
We wear two t-shirts. I'm hot.
I'm sweating.
Right.
I can't stand it. Okay, another thing. This is kind of weird. Your fingers shrink when it's cold.
Yeah, your jewelry falls off. Yeah.
I never knew that.
Right.
It constricts blood vessels in places like your hands and feet to keep your core temperature up. So if you're wearing a wedding ring, it will get looser.
Well, yeah, and it's like here
I thought I was losing weight.
Right. Well, here our rings fit. When we went to Wiggins' wedding, they barely fit. You know what I mean?
Oh.
It was so like, we're like, it was jam so it on.
Yeah. You know, I love the humidity because that's the only time my hair looks good, and I've never been like, oh man, I got good hair. But when I get down to humidity levels, I'm all,
look at my hair. Look at me.
And I'm the opposite. My hair goes super flat.
Right.
So humidity is not my friend in pictures.
Well, you looked good for your wedding wig.
No, actually, my hair was blown because of the wind.
Well, yeah, that was crazy.
It definitely looks like it just is terrible hair. So I was like, it doesn't look like humid hair. That's why I'm so mad, because I was like, the one time I could have had amazing hair and I didn't put enough product.
These pictures last forever. Right.
Hey, you weren't going to rival the bride anyway. Everybody was looking at her.
Yeah, she was beautiful. It can affect your vision, the cold temperature can.
Why? Because your eyes get smaller in the cold?
Being out in the cold too long can freeze your corneas, which can lead to blurred vision and light sensitivity. That's crazy.
That's scary. And you got to think about like poor people that like have to, you know, find some place to sleep.
Well, there's snow blindness too, isn't that what it's called?
Right, where
that's so white out.
Yeah,
that's when you're skiing. Like, that's happened to me before while I was skiing, and especially when it's snowing. So it's like you literally, like even as a kid, I felt like I was high and I wasn't because the snow gets so crazy that you can't tell the difference between the sky and the ground.
That's crazy.
And so you're moving fast.
Right.
And so you won't be able to decipher where there's a mogul or a turn or a bump.
Oh.
So you kind of just have to stop and catch your breath and try to shake it off. It's pretty crazy.
You don't just announce on the mountain, hold on.
Hold on. Yeah. It's like you wait for one of those guys in the snowmobile to cart you down. Hold on. An avalanche. Is coming.
Another thing that affects your body in the cold weather, your face gets red. It totally does.
Yeah, and that's why when you first come in from outside, you look like, oh, I have rosacea.
Your body has to redirect more blood to your vital organs when you're cold. So the another thing that happens, whoopsie, heart attack. Heart attack risks go up.
Because people are shoveling or just because they're cold?
No, when you're cold, your heart has to work harder to pump the blood.
Oh, wow.
So it's more susceptible to a heart attack.
So stay indoors, fatty.
Well, keep grandma out. You know.
No, grandma's got a shovel.
No.
Because she doesn't use it, she'll lose it.
That is true. You have to stay active, everybody.
Come on, grandma.
Somebody on the text line just said, Kathy, what place has the best chicken mac and cheese? It's called Tupelo Honey. Like, and it's it's all recipes from North Carolina or something where they started it, but it's so good. Like, it's definitely go stop at the Green Solution and then head on over to the Tupelo Honey.
I'd like everybody to know that, like, if you ever see me, Larry, in public, sometimes you might, like, say, well, that's not plant-based what he's eating. Shut up. Because plant-based people can compromise every once in a while.
Can you?
Well, for Thanksgiving,
are
I was
you supposed to?
Well, there's no rules. I didn't sign anything. But the thing is, I'm trying to, you know, think of animals, stuff like that. But, you know, I'm not crazy. Like, I went to Lost Delicious with Chris.
Yeah, and what'd you have?
I ate a chicken. I mean, not a chicken. A cheese enchilada. So I had cheese.
He's the boring friend.
Listen, and I had a burrito, a bean burrito, smothered in their chili, which clearly is
had
soaking
pork
in pork.
Look at you.
I know, but I'm saying for the right meal and the moment, like I'm like Lost Delicious means a lot to me. It's about my heritage. It's about growing up here.
You're the one that got me hooked on Lost Delicious.
Exactly.
You love them.
Yeah, for sure. And the restaurants are consistent. No matter which one you go to, it tastes the same.
Was that the one that was over there? What was that one that was next to us?
No, that was La Loma.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah. That was over here?
I just heard the La.
La Loma has great food, too, but now they're right by the Brown Palace, so kind of hard to find parking.
That's the thing, is I went, and it was delicious. The margarita is just as good as I remember.
Amazing
but
nachos.
But the parking was a nightmare.
Yeah.
I had to pay $15 to find parking around, you know.
And
they were like, well, we valet at night. Well, you know what? I ain't going to be here tonight. I'm going to be home with my family. Mm-hmm. I'm going to enjoy, I come here for business meetings.
I think they might have to have upped the prices a little, too, because of going into
downtown.
Right. So it is a little more of a, because sometimes you go to Mexico and you're like, hey, I want a good deal. And so Lost Delicious is perfect. And the thing is, I used to be so mad at them because their salsa is so hot.
Uh-huh.
And it like ruins my whole chips and salsa experience.
Totally. Right.
You just can't handle it.
No.
Sometimes it's super hot.
It really is super hot. And I'd be so mad at them, but I couldn't get mad at them because once you order, your food is there in 30 seconds.
Yeah, totally.
And it's piping hot.
This is Larry. Lost Delicious has a vegan green chili.
Vegan.
My bad.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
And you know what? It was cool because Chris and I went there and the girl, this was the one that they just redid, the one on 18th across from D-Bar. And the girl that was working, that was seating people recognized me. And then one of the owners, one of the brothers that owns Las Delicious, comped our meal. He was like super nice.
Oh, that's cool.
By the way, he's coming to our happy hour tonight at Alamo Draft House to try the Blazin' Hit Radio drink.
Oh my God, I hope he brings some chips and salsa.
No, it's too hot.
This text came in. You guys need a bumper sticker / window cling event. My kids' high school friends were like, they're back? Yes, get the word out.
Yeah, exactly. There's a bunch of people that are walking around bumping into things, not laughing in the morning. They're all mad.
Coming to work all grumpy.
Right, and they turn on a station and all they hear is, oh, blah, 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 blah. Right. So, yeah, they just kind of like didn't realize we're back.
Yes.
Right. So now, everybody, please tell. Share the news. Let's all laugh again.
You know how like we're famous for coming up with promotions when we're live on the air?
Well, you are.
Okay. Oh, here we go.
Larry, I thought this was a brilliant idea.
Oh, no.
Okay, so basically what we would do...
We're not doing it now, though, right?
To get the word out. This is preliminary.
Okay.
But what we would do is we would say, hey, we want you to... text all your friends. Do a mass text.
Okay. Group text.
Group text with our link in it and say, hey, Larry and Kathy are back. Uh-huh. And then you send that text to all the people in your phone or however many you can hold in a mass text.
Right.
And then you screenshot that. And then you send that picture to us at our number at 303-728-3420. And we see proof that, whoa, that person tagged 10 people to let them know that we were back with a link to our app. So then we say, out of all those people that sent, that's how you enter the contest.
We've thrown this idea around before.
Right. So everybody, that's how you enter the contest, by taking a screenshot of your mass text. And then we're going to pick one of those people to win like a huge gift card.
So are you trying to get out of our meeting this afternoon, and so you're trying to throw out the idea now on the air?
No. I get so excited when I'm driving in.
I'm like, because that was
the first thing I told Kathy.
Brainstorming.
I know, but
thing.
I was so excited. I thought clearly they're going to love this. Yeah. So I told. That was the first thing I told Kathy when I walked in. I was like, I have this great idea. She's like, present it at the meeting.
Thank you, Kathy.
I'm on your
thank
team.
You, Kathy.
Here's
high
the five. Thing. Here's right, thing. I'm right here with you.
This is the meeting.
No, it's yes, not. It is. Live.
I like when we have on-air meetings.
No.
All right, now we're going to segue to sexual harassment.
We're
going to
give away $1,000
right now. Would you like to own your own green solution? Yeah. Caller 10 right now at 303-728-3420.
We got to have them approve that first.
Love you on the text line. When I'm laughing with you guys in the car on the way to work, I want to shout out to all the people. They're back, everyone. Don't you know they're back? LMAO, you need the window clings or something. I agree with the other caller.
For sure. We definitely need to get the word out, and you know that'll come via marketing and stuff like that. But you know, we definitely need to shout it from the rooftops.
Yeah, well, what is fun is yesterday was our first simulcast, and we're working out the kinks and edges as we do with
that
the
sounds
app.
Sexy.
Yeah, we've been working out the kinks
since we started.
Those kinks, baby.
Yeah, right.
This is one kink.
Oh, yeah. I got a kink
you got
in my leg.
That's
I need
not,
to drink water.
That's
I'm
not
dehydrated.
A kink, Kathy. That's not a kink. That's something else.
That's a cramp. Yeah.
Is it? Is that what they're calling it?
Yes.
But so we're going live on Facebook as we do the show simultaneously. So you guys hang out in the big comfy chairs, and so people can interact. But the best part about that was that literally people were, oh my god, but they thought that was the show. I'm gonna have to watch this every time. It's like, no, there's an app.
We're on the air every morning.
Yeah,
and it's like if you have somewhat of a little, if you're a little tech savvy, you already know how to get the show in the car.
Yeah,
but there are some people who have been like, well, what do I do?
Right.
And you're like, okay,
it's a lot easier than you think.
Right.
Cell phones have come a long way.
Mm-hmm.
Most of us have unlimited data.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Make sure you're on a Wi-Fi when you're somewhere that you can be listening to it.
Right.
And download it and hit play.
And if it's on your Bluetooth, like now when I get in my car, it just starts playing.
Yeah, mine too.
All right.
So we'll probably go here Facebook Live here in a little bit.
That's why I said crap earlier. I got to go up and
get the makeup
on.
You actually look really cute. Your hair's already done.
Yeah, the hair's done. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah, so
I'm parting down the middle today.
Maybe. It's adorbs.
Thanks. I saw a brunette yesterday, and I was like, maybe I should start parting down the middle again.
It's cute.
What if we created something? Because I don't know makeup. I don't
ooh,
do this.
A face.
A face where it's like spray paint, to where you just cover it up like a stencil or a tinsel, and then go, and then the eyes are done,
you're a straight guy.
Is this something you should be bringing up in the meeting?
Yeah,
I don't
exactly.
know if this is something for the radio.
This is distracting. We're trying to get to a meeting.
I go dumb, I go stupid, I get crazy.
Come on
It's Kathie J's Stupid News.
Have y'all seen the trailer for the new Avengers movie?
Yes, it was super dope.
Oh my God, Black Panther's in it.
I know.
Oh my God, Spider-Man's wearing his armored costume.
Right, and so was, wasn't the Hulk in one of the, he was like in his Iron Man get-up too.
Yeah, right. He was in one. Vision is kind of looking human in it.
Right.
Thanos is in it.
Yeah, like, it looks pretty sick.
Yeah, so it looks really sick. 38 million views yesterday. That's how excited we all are for that. And to know that this is going to be the last one.
That's what you said yesterday. Yeah, that they said, we're going to bring a movie that nobody's ever seen.
But that's stupid news?
Oh, this... No,
we're
I thought you said trash
news.
And bash.
No, we're in stupid news right now.
Yeah, I was waiting for it to get stupid.
Yeah,
I was like,
sorry. What is so stupid about that?
So
I was like, that is the coolest thing
Kenny
ever.
Kenny has a lot of stuff. Yeah, I'm so sorry. Right. Okay, let's go over here to this pile.
Stupid news.
I'm so sorry.
Come on, there's nothing stupid about that movie.
No, there wasn't anything stupid.
Maybe Justice League.
Not kidding.
I like Justice League.
They're just... DC is just not as good as Marvel.
Have you seen Justice League?
I didn't like. Oh, not Justice
Justice
League.
You
not
seen
Justice
it?
League. No, but I saw
Superman,
Batman.
Was so stupid.
You can't judge it on that.
You can't. A guy. Let's get into stupid news, shall we? Okay. A guy hid his phone in a potato bag, in a potato chip bag, to keep his boss from tracking him.
Oh, is that work?
While he went and played golf.
So the is it like the what the bag's made of that blocked it?
I don't know what he was thinking. To be honest with you, so it's a 60-year-old dude. His name is Tom. He's from Australia.
Okay.
Kind of reminds me of your stepdad.
Okay.
Like, golfing is Tom's life.
Okay.
Okay? Like, Pat loves golfing, right?
For sure.
So, he had a job as an electrician a couple years ago.
Uh-huh.
And you kind of make your own day up, you know, when you're an electrician.
Right, for sure.
You get
your
job done early, you got time.
Sure, to golf.
Exactly. So, he loved skipping work and playing golf. Unfortunately, he knew that the new company he's with would track his location using the cell phone, because they all have it.
Right, he was working for, like, the company that didn't have that technology, and now they do.
Now they do. So, he improvised. He figured if he put his phone in an empty bag of potato chips, that it would block the GPS
cell signal.
The foil lining does block.
It does?
The aluminum really does. I found that out. The aluminum is the real deal, that it blocks off the signal for everything.
The foil lining in the bag does block GPS signals, but...
His phone's all oily and greasy
right,
now.
Yeah, that's true. Tom was still an idiot, because even though the company couldn't track his phone in the bag, they could just go to the golf course and see the records for Tom's 140... golf outings.
Damn.
Yeah. Work commission panel just fired him.
He better be a good golfer.
Yeah,
for golfing that much.
Right. Now Tom is working as an Uber driver.
You know he got salt in his charger hole.
Oh, he had to, right?
Right?
I mean, you got to protect
some crumbs,
that. No, definitely, right. It gets everywhere.
It's not charging right.
A guy who stole a Ferrari got busted when he asked people, "Can I have some gas money?"
He's like, seriously, I just need to get home.
Right.
But just like a couple bucks.
Could you imagine you're at a gas station and doing a Ferrari asks you for gas money?
That would be a first.
I'd be like, screw you.
Right.
I mean, no way. I'm not helping you.
Coming in here, ask me for gas money.
Uh-huh.
And I said, dude, I don't have any cash. He's all, well, you just used a credit card to pay for that there. I was like, yeah, because I have money. I was like, and then I went inside, and then he followed me inside. He's like, will you buy me a Red Bull? And I was like, no.
You're the worst date ever.
Yeah.
I've bought stuff for people before. Like, one time I put $20 into his tank, and then I let him get breakfast. So he got like a little sandwich thing and a banana for the rest of the day.
I thought you were going to say, and I let him get a feel. I was like,
I'll put $20 in his tank.
You pay me for that. Okay, so a 38-year-old guy, Israel. He wandered into a Ferrari Maserati dealership in California last month, and he saw a Ferrari. Not just any Ferrari, the 458 Spider.
That sounds expensive.
Yes. It was in their garage getting serviced, and someone left the keys on the seat.
Whoa, yeah, it's just a press to start.
Exactly. Like, oh, well, let me just jump into this little Ferrari and take off.
Better know
off.
How to shift.
2 weeks later, he still had the Ferrari and was driving it around. He pulled into a Shell gas station, started asking people, I borrowed some gas money. And that was very suspicious.
Right.
The 458 Spider, just so everyone knows, they start. The base package is $230,000.
Wow. And it used to be maybe back in the day you could do like a gas run where you'd fill the gas and then take off.
Yeah.
But now it's like every gas pump's like, enter your card number first.
Right.
So you really have to ask people for money.
You don't have any. Right. Yeah. Because
you could get away fast in that car if you're doing a gas boogie.
Yeah. All right. Peace out. Yeah. You ain't got nothing on me, copper. This one was worth about $300,000. Somebody called the cops and said, this dude out here, I don't think this is his Ferrari. They found him hiding in some bushes behind a Holiday Inn nearby and arrested him. So he abandoned the Ferrari.
Right, because it had no gas.
The Ferrari belonged to a lady named Susan.
Who's so rich, didn't even know her Ferrari was missing.
I wonder if the shop, like, if you lose the Ferrari you're servicing, do you tell the owner or do you just try to find it on your own for 2 weeks?
Right, for sure. Or, again, so wealthy that she's like, oh, keep it for as long as you ever need. I don't know, whatever.
Who knows? It was a pretty white Ferrari. Here's the thing, though. Israel trashed the Ferrari so bad that the insurance company declared it a total loss.
Wow.
That means he pooped in the cup holder.
She used the settlement from the Ferrari to buy a new 2018 Lamborghini.
Oh, that's good. So, upgrade. Yeah.
Wow, Susan.
Upgrade.
Susan knows her cars. That's your stupid news.
Larry and Kathy's Blazin' Hit Radio.
Rise and shine.
We're back.
Every morning.
I'm Larry Ulibarri. That's Kathy J. And over there, that little hottie's Wiggins.
Yeah. And we are live on Facebook right now, streaming. And we are also on the app. So if you're watching us on Facebook and you haven't downloaded the app yet, Larry and Kathy J. are live every morning, 5 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on Blazin' Hit Radio.
Right. And this mysterious hand is producer Bolte.
Yeah. Kathy, you got to talk right into that. This isn't the everyday show. Okay. We got no lavaliers.
Quit putting that in my face, Bolte. No, I'm kidding. Okay, there you go.
Speaking of,
thank you. I think that
people
can't.
Not everybody can see you, so this is just audio. Yeah. Some people.
I thought we were on Facebook.
We are both, but most people are still listening to the car, so they don't get what's happening when you're being silent and you're like,
sorry, everybody. They're trying to put a mic in front of my face, and yesterday it kept falling on me. So Bolte's being polite enough to try to get it right for me.
For sure, bouncing ball. So wait a minute. Okay, here's the thing. I got kicked off Facebook.
What?
Yeah. You deserve to get kicked off Facebook for that. I'm sorry.
Okay, what did he post? What did you post? Okay,
let me just explain. Calm down, everybody. This guy on my feed was like, he's funny. He's just like a guy. And he's like, I'm taking submissions of what kind of tattoo I should get.
Okay.
So then I immediately just Googled man lower back tat, because I wanted to post something funny.
Right. And lower back tats on men are hilarious.
Right. So there was this one picture of a guy that it was his lower back, but it was also like the top part of his butt was also tattooed.
Okay.
It's a lot more graphic.
Okay.
Well, whatever.
You mean the tattoo itself?
The picture.
Okay.
So it's his butt.
So it shows full butt.
Right.
Okay.
And so I thought, I'm not posting this as a post. I'm putting in somebody's thread and like somebody that would be like, that was funny.
Okay.
So obviously somebody in the thread was like, I saw
it. No,
that.
I don't think it was really graphic and like what?
How is a butt graphic?
It was like a giant butt being peeled apart.
That's not true. That is not true.
You didn't say that it was being peeled.
That is not true.
Okay. It looked like it.
Okay,
then.
That's not true.
All right. Show me the picture in question.
I had to remove it.
Show me this picture.
Yeah, and so it's not some guy spreading.
But you can't, just because you don't post it on your profile doesn't mean
it still goes to you.
Yeah, you're still responsible for posting that out there. So you can't just throw that up there. Like, there's a reason Facebook nudity and all that stuff isn't running rampant all over the site.
That's true.
And they know when those things are coming up.
Oh, yeah.
They like, Facebook has a team.
I think it was probably somebody that was like, that was way crazy that you posted that butt picture. It may be on my phone because I can't find it.
Okay.
Here, I'm just going to do lower back.
No, it's fine.
But, he was making it sound way worse than it was.
If I was a Facebook standard, I would be like, no, we're going to.
What did Facebook say? Just remove it?
He's been blocked for 48 hours from posting on the Facebook profile.
Before. You know what? You could use the time off.
Yeah.
Hey, I have 4 other pages, so.
Right, you're going to be fine.
I'm not going anywhere.
He's still going to reach you, everybody. You'll be fine.
It was just a tattooed butt. Everybody's calm down.
Again, not everybody sees nudity the way you like to.
Well, I mean,
really,
I thought like
to.
Now that, like, I figured that every year that goes by, people get used to things a little more.
Mm.
So I think we're just literally like months away from being able to say certain curse words in sitcoms. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Like, they start with ass, and then they went to son of a bitch. And, now it's going to be like the S word or something.
Right.
So I think that pretty soon, eventually, you'll see a tattooed man's butt and be like, whatever. You know what I mean? You know what I mean?
No,
we don't. Here.
Or is it going backwards, Larry?
Oh, I don't know.
Because with all these sexual harassment claims coming out, one after another, Matt Lauer. Now this, everybody. Russell Simmons has stepped down from his businesses, and we all know he has plenty, from the credit cards to Def Jam, all that. He has stepped down from the allegations of the model Carrie Clausen in her November 19th article in LA Times. He came out on like 3 days later and said, no, that wasn't true. I didn't do that. But now someone else came out and said, well, let me tell you in detail then, Mr. Simmons, what you did. And that has caused him to go, I need to step down.
Right. It's like
investors don't want to deal with this.
These all have the same thing in common in the sense that it's always a rich guy,
mm-hmm.
and it's always, this was a one-off.
Right.
And then 30 other chicks come out. And so, yeah, the girl that was talking about him and that director, she said that
they're like sitting in the same room or something.
Right, right. And she felt like it was closing in on her, or that Russell was.
Right.
And she looked to the director to be like, yo, hook it up, help me out here. And he like, I must disappear.
Mm-hmm. And this girl is the granddaughter of singer and activist Lena Horne. So, okay.
It's like, why are these people so dumb to hit on people that know the business or that have a name?
Have connections.
Right. Yeah, right. Like, she's also the daughter of filmmaker Sidney Lumet.
Okay.
And she herself is an award-winning screenwriter.
Wow.
Right. So now she is, but this happened back in the day. She's talking about when she met him in like 1987 with Rick Rubin, who she said was always nice to me. She ran in the clubs that they were always in. He was a fan of her grandmother, Lena Horne. What are you doing, Larry?
I'm drinking water like Trump.
Oh, my God. I was like, what's happening over here? Anyway, so she's just trying to... I won't go into the detail on the...
Right,
you can read it, but another guy's stepping down.
Yeah, exactly. It's like it's never ending. Please let it end.
Well, so we got the audio from when Matt Lauer, because Matt Lauer just got busted on the Today Show, or got removed from the Today Show for his actions on Ed MBC.
Terminated was
the word.
He actually had an interview with Bill O'Reilly, where he called Bill O'Reilly off.
A couple years ago. No. So he interviews Bill O'Reilly when all of it was going down on Bill.
Well, that's weird that Bill would even show up for an interview. You know what I mean? It's like
don't you think he was trying to save face?
Right,
because Bill's still saying those girls are lying.
That's the same.
Okay.
Trump says the same thing.
But check this out, the way Matt Lauer framed the question to Bill O'Reilly.
You were the guy that the ratings and the revenues were built on. You carried that network on your shoulders for a lot of years. So doesn't it seem safe to assume that the people at Fox News were given a piece of information or given some evidence that simply made it impossible for you to stay on at Fox News?
So it's like a question when he comes back and does his first interview.
Right,
I hope someone reads that verbatim to him and has him answer it.
Right, for sure.
I, that's a false assumption. There were a lot of other business things in play at that time and still today that 21st Century was involved with. And it was a business decision that they made. But there isn't any
But you don't let your number one guy go unless you have information that you think makes him.
That's not true.
Totally. No, Matt's right. Matt's right. You don't let your number one guy go that gives you all that money if there's not a huge allegation of a lawsuit.
Tens of dollars at stake in business deals, and they made a business decision that they could, possibly prosper more without me. It was as simple as that. It was a business decision.
Did you ever send a lewd text or email to another employee at Fox News?
No.
Did you ever have any human resources cases brought against you?
Not in 42 years.
Because I was hooking it up with the HR lady.
Well, didn't they have, payouts, settlements that Fox had to pay on behalf of Bill O'Reilly?
Right.
That's what Matt Lauer asked.
Okay, good.
In 42 years, all right, I've been in this business. I've worked for 12 companies. Not one time did I have any interaction with HR, any complaints filed against me.
Because he was too big. They were like, it was kind of like they're saying the Matt Lauer thing.
Nobody wanted to fire him.
Right. Nobody wanted to, like NBC, the bigwigs there couldn't even really, they can make suggestions, but today was so big a monster, a ratings moneymaker, that they kind of made their own rules. And that's how Matt Lauer got away with it so long, because everybody was just like, well, this is his show.
It's Matt.
Right. And it's like, he got
Ann Curry fired.
Right.
Right.
New York Times reported that up to five women had come forward over the years and complained about sexual harassment at your hands, and that Fox News actually made deals with those women, financial settlements amounting to about $13 million for their silence. Is that accurate?
I don't know, because I'm not privy to what Fox News did.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
You know what? What I would have given to be a hot lady at Fox during the last 5 years.
You could have made millions.
Exactly, because Gretchen Carlson was the one that was the first one to get like paid out $20 million.
She did?
Yeah, but then everybody thought that was a lot. And then the girl that really they paid $38 million to for what O'Reilly did to her,
uh-huh.
And she was on there all the time. So we're like, when you pay 30-some million, what did he do to her? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's like she must have been leaving his office every time like, I can't see.
Oh, God. Okay.
Yeah, or whatever. I don't know what he did. I can't walk. Something. $38
million. We're also talking to people on the text line this morning. And this person says, earlier we were talking about the new Green Solution location that's going to be opening up off of like 19th and WeWada.
Right, right.
And so I was telling you guys.
UWada? No.
No, WeWada. WeWada.
Right.
That's cute. Try it again.
No, it's all right.
UWada?
WeWada.
There you go. And there's a restaurant that I have fallen in love with. It's the Bomb. That's like at 17th and WeWada. And like the whole area is crazy. It's high rises. And have you been down there, Bolte? Not yet.
When you look
it's
downtown,
insane. There's a new Whole Foods there. I mean, not that I ever shop at Whole Foods.
Right? Who wants $12 chicken salad?
True.
But when you look downtown now, it's all cranes. It's like there's mm-hmm. like 10 cranes. So yeah, our landscape is vastly changing.
So this one says, "I love Tupelo Honey as well, Kathy. Have you had their cat head biscuits? That's what they call their big biscuits because they're the size
of a
cat head.
Okay, I don't eat chicken or cow. I'm not going to eat a cat's head.
whatever.
I think that's kind of cool.
Whatever. I have tried the cat head biscuits. They are bomb. They're delicious.
Okay.
This one says, when I'm laughing with you guys in the car on the way to work, I want to shout out to people. They're back, just like that other texter said.
Well, we'd really appreciate it if you could.
We really do, right.
Because it's word of mouth.
This one says, I want a shirt and a beanie with your logo on it.
It really is word of mouth, and a lot of people don't, even people on Facebook Live right now that are watching you guys. Like yeah. We have a huge following on Facebook Live, but those guys are like, oh, you're back, you're on Facebook Live, and they think that's the app. But
right.
It's like,
no, this isn't it. Facebook Live isn't how you hear us every morning and throughout the day. You've got to go to Blazin Hit Radio, download the free app, you will find us.
If you're on Facebook right now, you're seeing, this is where we live in this, like, you know, little concrete room.
Graffiti area.
That has graffiti
everywhere.
Are we
everywhere. In the graffiti area?
Yes.
Yeah. I was hoping we'd be like, you know, when we get closer to Christmas, can we put up that...
the Brown Palace lobby.
Yeah, the Brown Palace
with
lobby.
The tree.
I was thinking of just a nice running stream.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, a little snow behind right. you. Well, we'll be able to control a lot. When we do like the Matt Lauer stuff, we'll literally be able to throw that up behind you guys.
No, that's awesome.
You know what I'd like to put up there is that butt picture that I got kicked off Facebook for to see what you guys think.
Really?
About
you want to put that on Facebook
right,
Live?
Right, then we'll get kicked off again.
Yeah, never go not, on Facebook Live happening. Again. Yeah.
And then you'll only
find
have
it.
Two
I've been
pages
looking for
to talk to people with.
It.
So, you know, what's crazy is a lot of people were blowing us up yesterday, even after the show, about the former coworker situation.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And some people didn't have the full grasp on what happened with that, but they're excited you're back. Do you want to kind of go into that again and kind of rehash?
Yes, I will do it.
What do they still want to know about?
No, he's saying that some people didn't catch the
some
whole
people
story.
Didn't catch it, and that's what they're saying on Facebook.
Gotcha.
Okay. So I'll recap it really fast.
Okay.
Okay.
Should I get out a stopwatch for this?
No.
Okay.
under 30 seconds.
Can you do it? I'll do it under 60 seconds and left?
Yeah.
How much
okay.
60 seconds or
okay.
less.
Okay. Wait. Let me put it on the clock. The clock will start now.
Okay, we worked with Kendall for 15 years. It was really good, and we had a great relationship, and we had a very successful show, number one show in Denver. And then toward the end, he wasn't liking us. His wife hated us. And so all of a sudden, the last year, he didn't talk to us very much. And then he started talking to the company saying he wanted to go to California, and he didn't tell us any of that. So he kind of tried to dip out without saying anything. And then when they re-signed us, they didn't re-sign him. And so we ended up figuring out that they were going to offer us a bad deal, and then we didn't like the deal. And so we put our name out there. And then all of a sudden, Green Solutions like, hey, we'll take you guys, and just the two of you, because that other guy just only introduce songs and stuff. And so we're together now with Wiggins, and we are at the Blazin Hit Radio studio.
35 seconds.
All right.
Yeah, you did it. Good job. Yeah. I'm shocked. You had another, I don't know, math. 25 seconds?
Yeah, fine. Well, truth be told, because he said 30.
Faulty? Is that 25?
Yeah.
Okay, right. 30 it is.
So here's the thing. It's like... we were close, all of us, and it's kind of rare that a show would stay together as long as we did anyway.
Mm-hmm, but it was just effortless for us. We really had a good time.
Right, no, for sure. And then just one thing came up, and we just, you know, things changed between us and him, and, you know, him not trying to do stuff on the download didn't, you know, sit right with us.
Mm-hmm.
So, whatever. We don't wish him ill will or whatever.
No.
Glad that he's living in Cali and, you know, recording his show and putting it here, whatever he wants to do.
Right.
But, you know, we're doing our thing.
But when Westward articles come out and they kind of have some lies in
them. Well, that made me mad for Kendall to act like he was in the dark when he was the one that was leaving us in the dark.
Yeah.
I mean, there were times that I specifically said,
Do you want to say anything?
Do we need to talk about something?
No.
And he would pull his headphones off, because for a while he didn't ever talk to us. He would just keep his headphones on.
The last year.
And he, it was started around the summer, but for sure. And then he was like, no, what are you talking about? And I was like, I can't get it out of you that way. You know, like, I'm, after 15 years, I just was hoping we could have communicated better at the end.
He's non-confrontational too, so.
Right, and he always said that. If you listened all those years, you knew Kendall didn't like confrontation.
And the thing was, we were, with him in the room when the guy that was on with Kelly, live with
Michael Strahan.
Right.
Right.
And he kind of dipped out on her without telling her what happened.
Exactly.
So he dipped out and he went and made a deal with Good Morning America.
Right.
And that's why she was so pissed.
Right.
And she was off the air for like a day or so to just get herself together.
Right, because she was like, we were a team. You couldn't communicate with me that you wanted to do this?
Right, and so we asked him at the time, and we're like, isn't that weak
that
he would
do
that to her? And he was like, yeah. And he was doing it to us.
Right.
So,
well, this text came in, 303-728-3420. And if you have the app, you can send in a shout out or just text us or call us straight from it. Would you guys be willing to have Kendall on the show to clear the air?
No way.
Yeah.
I mean, it's already cleared. There's nothing to clear. We don't wish him ill will, and he went to do his own thing, and whatever. We had a good run.
We had a great run.
Right. So, I mean, I wouldn't have him on just because...
To clear that.
Toward the end, he literally wasn't really saying much to us anyway. So, you know...
We still have love for him. We hope the best for him. We spent
I wouldn't go crazy.
I still have love for him.
I'm just saying, you know, like, I don't wish him ill will. Is what
I'm
saying.
Exactly.
And so, whatever. You know, it's like we had a good run.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
So, South Park, Larry, you guys were auditioning earlier for DIA, or you still are, right? You still have to send that in.
Right.
Okay, so South Park has a chance for you to be a character.
What?
You could win it.
Oh, my God. This is awesome.
My God. Okay.
Hello, I'm Trey Parker.
And I'm Matt Stone.
And we'd like to offer you the chance to come hang out with us here at South Park Studios.
We'll fly you to L.A., put you up in a fancy hotel, and bring you here and give you a tour of where we do the show.
Sounds pretty great, doesn't it?
Yes.
No.
No, it doesn't.
It doesn't.
But how about this? We'd like to offer you eternal life. You see, in South Park, besides the main characters, we also have what's called random townspeople. These are the people you always see rah, 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 yelling at the mayor and running down the street from volcanoes. We use them all the time.
We want to use your likeness, use your voice, and you will forever be part of the South Park community.
Wow. You'll sit in this chair where one of our artists will draw your exact likeness to be forever put into the show. Of course, it'll be up to you if you want us to remove any of your blemishes or enhance any of your features. And then you'll stand in this line and wait to eat craft service with everyone else.
Mm. Then you'll be here in our studio recording your voice so we can have your voice always attached to your character.
No, you shut your mouth, pal!
That's cool.
And finally, you'll come and sit on this couch and play board games with us when we should be working on the show.
Yay!
Oh, do not move your Vikings into there.
They're
playing
Risk.
Want to miss this opportunity for eternal life.
So for your chance to be drawn into the show, click the link or go to omaze.com/South Park to enter.
Every donation supports Next for Autism and their mission to improve the lives of everyone living with autism spectrum disorder.
Enter now, and hopefully we'll see you soon.
That's cool.
Yeah. Wow, that's cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So it's not really like
a regular gig.
Voice gig. It's more of just
auditioning. You can be on the show.
Yeah. You can be on the show, and it's for a great cause. My nephews have autism, so it's cool to bring awareness, and I've learned so much about... All right, so Mason and Roman, you guys actually met them.
They're adorable. I love them.
Amazing kids, super smart. They freaked out at the wedding when they were huge wrestling fans. And so here's the thing about them. They're huge wrestling fans.
How old are they now?
They're 13, 12, 13. And so when you literally talk to them about wrestling, they know everything. They when they find something and they get into it, they absorb everything about it. So I'm literally sitting there like, how about that Stone Cold WWF Championship in 1996? And they're all, well, actually, he should have won based on that.
So they get down.
With presidents,
I remember you
Jacksons.
Told me when you first started dating Kayla and met them, it was like baseball at the time or something.
It was football. They're really into football.
And you were just like, these kids are so smart.
But what you realize is it's autism is just so is a visual stimulation. Like they just see things differently, and once you really realize what it is that they go through, it's cool to get behind causes like that to
absolutely
raise awareness.
Right, for sure. That's totally cool.
No, for sure. We definitely got to send in a tape. We all should audition.
I was gonna say back to us being South Park.
Right, exactly. Yeah. I want to play board games with them.
Yeah, Larry, what voice would you do? Do you think
I don't
know?
I mean, they're probably just looking for. They don't need an impression. They just want a crazy voice or whatever. Right. Probably gonna pick somebody who's like. You know, maybe talks like this.
You need to have something. Yeah. Something that they can't
stand
do.
Out.
Right, because they do everything.
Right. They're hilarious.
Right.
So 303-728-3420. Again, you can shout us out in the app. You can call us or text us. If you're watching on Facebook, you need to download the Blazin' Hit Radio app. We're going to take a break. We're going to keep going on Facebook Live, and then we'll be right back.
From the Mile High City.
And now, worldwide.
Blazin' Hit Radio.
It's that time of year again. It's time for you to write a letter on behalf of somebody else that may be not having the easiest go of it this holiday season. Mm-hmm. So we want you to nominate a friend, a family member, a coworker, and let us know what they need. You know, some people are like in a situation where, hey, I got the rent paid, but I don't have any for presents for the kids.
Right, or I don't have any groceries.
Right, for sure. So we're just looking for you to let us know about somebody in two paragraphs and send it to ChristmasWish@BlazinHitRadio.com, and we're going to start answering letters soon.
Exactly. Yep.
It's Blazin Hit Radio Morning Show Christmas Wish, and you can actually send those in to ChristmasWish@BlazinHitRadio.com. And thank you to the Green Solution because they're a huge part of it this year and making all those wishes possible.
Yes, of
absolutely.
Course. We feel that we are Denver's morning show because we're with you everywhere, and you guys send us photos every morning of how you're listening to us, and I love it. Like people go on hikes listening to us, they're walking the dogs, they're sitting at their cubicle.
Some people are, you know, on the toilet.
Exactly. So we got to give a shout out to Angel who did her Snapchat pic, and she actually works at the Green Solution at Edgewater.
Oh, wow, she looks cute.
Hi, Angel. We know you. Thank you for listening, girl. Love you.
Is that
you.
A filter or are those her real bunny ears?
Oh, well,
what
I don't
do you
know.
Think? What
I think she's
think?
A bunny.
The question is that her real hair?
It looks pretty good.
I really am jealous of it. Right. I have hair envy. Maybe I should start doing that.
Yeah, show us that picture
this
again.
This side goes this way and this one curls to the front.
I do like that. Okay,
it's
yeah, because it's
girl.
A combo. Because you got one yeah,
going
in
the
and
other
then
way
one
and
out.
One's coming in. Right?
I
do like how she does that. Speaking of attractive people,
mm-hmm.
there's this new.
What about me? No. All right. Crickets.
Maybe back in the day, yeah. But you're old school.
I put on some LBs, huh?
Remember those days you were in the gym?
Yeah, I remember
hot.
Those
that
days.
That was hot.
It was before 14-hour work days. I remember those days.
We're all lucky to have scored who we have.
Yeah, for real.
It's not messing
for real.
Up.
For yeah. real.
Suckers.
Okay, so there are things out there that actually can affect how attractive you are to other people.
Okay, suck in your gut.
That's definitely...
And then go like this. Kiss face.
Yes. Kiss face. Sucking, yes.
And then you have to put your forehead to camera to eliminate double chin.
Yeah, you do.
And then you have to smize. So let's do all those things at once. Ready?
How I just hit
yeah,
the
that,
mic.
That.
Okay, so you know how, first off, it has to do with your face, okay?
My big, ooh. Fat... face.
Yeah,
like okay. Sometimes, like, you know, it's all about the angle when you're taking pictures.
It really is.
About lighting.
It is.
So when you take it, before you take a selfie,
uh-huh.
Let's say you have a selfie stick, or let's say you don't, do a circle within the room you're standing in because the light will change drastically as you do that circle. So then you find which one is the best lighting.
Yeah.
And then you film your video from there or take your picture.
Thank you.
Well, it's just a thing. and then, like I said, forehead to camera to get rid of that.
You know, it does blow my mind when I go to take a selfie with somebody and I'm like, what are you doing even dropping the camera?
Right.
Even
oh, yeah.
To
if
our
they go
face.
Too low.
Up,
oh, yeah.
up. Can you climb on that ladder? Get a little higher.
Right, exactly.
Get a little higher.
So, can you put it on a drone?
I would if I could.
Yeah, but then if it gets too far, you just look like a fat person standing in a park. So it can't get too far. You know what I mean?
You're right. We all have angles. Right. Didn't the Kardashians say they take like 500 pictures to get the right angle? It's
for
something
sure.
insane.
Right,
who
right.
has that kind of time?
Well, and they're
they
already
do.
Pretty. You know what I mean? So it's like if they're struggling to get good selfies, how are we going to survive?
I totally agree. So anyways, a lot of it is, what is this?
Okay, this is WWE's Tyler Breeze. He used to come out with a selfie stick.
Are you? Are we in your basement? Is this your house? Or like Wiggins having his own show over there?
Okay, so this is the selfie.
This is the, yeah, take pictures music.
Okay, all right, you're done, WWE nerd. Okay, so.
He thinks everything's wrestling at, like, I think everything's gay.
That is true.
He comes out with a selfie. You were talking about selfies, whatever.
Even his wedding had wrestling in it.
And you know what? I think wrestling's gay. I think it's just for men to roll on.
Why don't you tell that to John Cena's face?
Yeah. Oh my God, he's so hot.
John Cena?
Yeah.
Now that's gay.
Exactly.
Anyways.
And his wife's super hot.
No, totally. Nikki Bella. I
don't think they're married. They're
not
married.
The Bella twins.
No, they're engaged.
They're engaged, right. Okay,
yes,
so.
They're not married. Thank you.
I still have a shot with her.
We also know that we watch the Divas as well as the Bella
that's
twins.
The only thing that's the only reason I know anything about wrestling is the Divas.
Right.
So that's my reference point. Uh-huh. So if it doesn't have anything to do with their storyline, I don't know.
I am.
And then the other thing is, you watch one of his shows, and none of the girls that are on that show are in the are on the wrestling show.
Well, they are. They're not as good.
This is like, and, well, one of them's funny because she has a Russian accent, and then she doesn't have a Russian accent on the show.
Okay, is that the Mrs. Chick?
No, that's Lana.
That Lana. She's okay. with the
Mrs. Chick is French. She's really she's really French.
Right.
So.
But the other chick, she's like got a great body.
Oh, okay.
Remember, she's
the redhead?
No. Oh. She's blonde and she's with the big guy.
Okay.
The big muscle dude.
I know who you're talking about.
Right. And he looks like Lana.
Right.
The caveman. Right. Okay. So, someone wanted to say good morning, guys.
They wanted me to sing, have you seen your childhood? Searching for the guy I used to be.
Okay. Someone said, why did I wait so long to find you? I can't believe that you guys are back. Someone just told me about you the other day. I'm so happy.
See? And like,
spread the word.
Here's what's crazy. That person's probably friends with us on social media.
Yep.
And we've been ringing the bell that we're back. And so social media, they really like to limit your reach because they want you to pay for it.
True. This one says, oh my God, I missed you guys. I gotta admit, I tried to listen to a different morning show. And then I tried another one and another one.
We all tried.
And oh my God, it's torture. It's so annoying. I can't believe that I finally have you guys again. Yay. We're
back,
so happy.
Bitches. You know what? She wanted a cool rider.
303-728-3420.
No, none of that. Oh, go ahead.
We got a text. Someone's got a picture. Because you send us pictures, GIFs, videos, whatever. Someone's on the way to the vet. Hopefully everything will be okay, they said. They got their two dogs. Doggy Avenger in there.
Oh my God. Your doggies are okay. I hope Daisy's okay.
You know what kills me is Yosh, you know, when he was younger, he'd just be so happy-go-lucky.
Right.
He would go to the vet. No problem, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And he'd walk in and just hang out, whatever, and then we'd get his little thing taken care of or whatever it was, and then we'd leave. So now, as he's gotten older and he's had that procedure on his leg, he shakes so much when we go to the vet.
Aww.
Like, and especially when you're in the room with him and they're about to come in the room, he, like, literally will back up in between our legs and try to just hide from the person. So we're just like, it's okay, buddy. He just hates the vet now.
Aww.
Have the vet come to you.
Yeah, well, we're not the Kardashians.
Okay, can we get back to this list about how attracted you are to somebody?
Sure.
Okay, so the first thing has to do with faces and asymmetric faces.
Right. The best faces on a guy is that, like, sunken with a square jaw. Mm. Like, have you seen that?
Like Superman.
Yeah, exactly.
Henry Cavill.
Yeah, some people
That's
have that.
A face.
Right.
Right.
Some people have bones in their face. Not me. Some people have bones.
I don't have bones in my face either.
Thank God we're live on Facebook so people can see that.
That's funny, too, because
we're the Campbell Soup kids.
Alec Baldwin was on 30 Rock. He was like, he was hanging with Liz Lemon had a boyfriend, and he wanted James Marsden. Yeah, I can't remember who it was. And no, it was the guy that was in the bubble.
Oh yeah,
and so
James Marsden.
No, it was John Hamm.
Oh okay.
And so,
oh yeah, yeah.
And so he was like, Liz, I want to be friends with him. He's like, he's the only person at NBC that still has bones in his face.
Like, that's hilarious. Yeah. That's, okay. All right. So, how old your parents were when they had you actually affects how attracted you are to somebody else. Isn't that crazy?
The older or younger they are, what's it?
Okay, so if your parents were over 30, you are less likely to be drawn to somebody with a young face. For women, it applies to both parents. If you're a guy, only your mom's age matters.
Your mom?
It was my mom. My parents were in their 20s, early 20s. Yeah.
Same with mine.
Right. So we're all attracted to young faces. That well, was an easy it? One.
I you rarely see somebody going, ooh, look at that old face. Love it.
Right. I can't get enough.
That's almost three chins. Wow.
Okay. So another thing that could make you attracted to somebody, being a bad speller. Here you go, Larry.
That makes me attracted to somebody? Because I'm like, can you help me spell?
Please save me. It comes into play a lot more now because of online dating. In a survey last year, 72% of people said if somebody couldn't pass a fifth grade spelling bee, it's a deal breaker.
So what are you supposed to hold a fifth grade spelling bee on the beginning of the date?
No, but you need to know a little bit.
So what, you send him some questions? You're all, spell the, because the guy could look it up. You got to ask him while you're Facebook Live.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Or I mean while you're FaceTiming.
I will say this. When I
Xylocarp.
Okay, don't get Xylocarp. Crazy on it. It could be simple things like.
Sharon Schnitter.
Sharon
Schnitter.
Golf setup. What was the other one?
The other one was Gazelle.
Gesellschaft.
Gesellschaft.
Oh my God, that was so funny. That okay. So no, I'm talking about when I dated Trucker Greg.
Okay.
Okay.
He wasn't the brightest, but he sure had pretty blue eyes.
He sure did.
And he knew how to drive a big rig.
Right. And you know, we all have different strengths and stuff.
For sure.
And spelling was not his strength.
Nor grammar.
I saved nor grammar.
I remember we were out one time, and we were, Chris and Kathie were in the TJ Maxx, and me and Mr. Truck Driver were waiting outside.
Yeah.
And somebody walked by, and they said something. I think they may have said hello to me.
Right.
And they were like, hello, Larry. And he goes, oh, wow, that person's speaking Britain.
Yeah, okay. Well, it doesn't matter. I loved him, okay? We're all stupid ones.
And I didn't even correct him. I was like, I'll let that flow.
But you never forgot it.
Right.
Okay, so.
I was like, I can't wait until Kathie comes out.
Did he have an accent? Was he
no,
all
no,
like,
no, no. He's from Greeley. Right. Okay. Right. And I love his daughter to this day.
He's a super sweet guy.
Right. Still super sweet. So, but the breakup letter that he left me when he moved out of the house.
Kathie had it graded by a second grade teacher. And it was an F.
I still remember it. It was horrible. Like, he didn't even say, I want to remain your friend. And friend, he didn't even.
It's all me go.
He didn't
take
even,
stuff.
He didn't put the I in there. So it was just F-R-E-N-D. Then he was like, but a piece of my heart will always be with you.
He's all and H-A-R-T.
Peace was spelled P-E-A-C-E, like peace and love.
Okay,
it wasn't peace
right,
of a heart.
Right.
Right. And I was just like, oh, you know what? Maybe this.
Was
like,
a blessing.
I kept the letter, and I
she would, framed it.
Every time
and
I was
we look
like,
at it to this
every
day.
Time I was like, Kathie, you miss him. Go back to him. Go back to him. I would pull the letter out and go, you're okay. You're doing okay, Kathie.
Kathie has the letter, and she shows it to her kids. She's like, this could have been your daddy.
Good, your daddy. Okay, another thing is if you're attracted to somebody or not. Red clothing. Now, I know this secret. You guys go crazy when a lady's wearing red.
I do.
Well, not you, Larry. Wiggins, producer Bolte.
I go
Bolte.
A different crazy. Like, I'm like, oh, you look amazing.
Yeah, that's a different. Fabulous.
Told you red was your color. You're a jewel tone.
Is it like the Matrix? Because it was the lady in red that he walked by.
It could
and
be.
Then they said, look again. And then he turned around and the gun was in his face.
That got deep.
That was Matrix 2, right?
The first Matrix.
Oh,
where
yeah,
they introduced him. Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
So a study in 2010 found that women are more attracted to guys in red because you are perceived as being more powerful if you have red on. So
same thing with
maybe
the tie.
That's
they say
Trump always
tie.
Wears a red tie.
Right.
Because maybe it's because he's playing off of that.
Yeah,
and
but then,
why
is the tie 4 inches too long?
So I don't know that.
I think he's like...
He's hiding his dinky-do.
Yeah, I was going to say, there's probably like a piece of metal in the end of the tie to protect anybody that took a shot at his junk.
Really?
You know, piece of lead to protect it.
I can see his ego doing something like that. The study, and then another study says that, of course, you guys love red. So much so that if women sat next to something that was red, you guys...
That thing she was sitting next to.
You guys would find the lady more attractive, the one that was even next to something red or sitting on a red chair. Isn't that crazy?
Well, this is terrible news because I don't own a lot of red. I mean, you don't see a guy in a bunch of red.
It's hard to work the red.
Right.
I mean, let's be honest.
A sweater.
Here. Right.
But if you show up and guys have less color choices, I think.
And this one is hilarious. I think I probably got, I think I probably had some good times because of this one. If you're a guy, how hungry you are matters.
If you're attracted to somebody?
If you're hungry, you're more attracted to a curvier woman. And then it's only temporary. Right. Once you eat, it doesn't apply anymore.
That is hilarious. So you cheat with the round girl who has a ton of food in her fridge.
Totally.
And then after you have sex, you leave because you're ashamed.
Story of my life.
You're like, eh.
Hey, but I want to point out, there were some guys and I that had some good times.
Stocked fridge.
Larry and Kathy J's Blazin' Hit Radio.
From the Mile High.
And now worldwide.
Welcome.
Hey, please wish Kathy and I good luck on our audition for the DIA voices.
Yes.
We are sending that in. We did some serious kind of takes on it because I think we have to get the job before we can start being super ad-libby.
Agreed. Like, if once we get the job, we'll be there for Lord knows how long and people will get used to us.
And I'm sorry, we did such a good job. I hate to blank our own blank, but we did it in a way that you would kind of hear at airport.
Yeah,
you
know, right.
Because, like, when you were there and you heard, there's a train coming. That was a powerful voice.
Yes, no, for sure. Alan Roach has an amazing voice. That's why he's the voice of so many
right.
sports things.
And so when Adele Arcaro says, you know, stand by, a train is coming, mm-hmm. it's very right. official.
I cover that part.
Right. So we did our kind of official announcer reads on it, but then we also included a couple, you know.
Well, can we show the people what it sounded like?
Well, yeah, you know, I think that the real audition we should put up on Facebook later to get people talking about it.
Yeah,
you know, to say, hey, DIA, choose
These
them
are
because
the ones.
They are Ooh, DIA like is going off of the social media push that the talent adds to it.
Oh, cool!
Like a Twitter campaign,
right? Exactly. I mean, they're not fools.
Right. So we need you guys to back us on this.
And since we have the most reach out of any of the Denver talent,
right.
In the market, we need to push it today.
Right, and then if we get the gig, then you know you'll hear us all the time when you're traveling or picking somebody
that'll be
up.
Great, we'll be there.
Hey, everybody, welcome to Denver. It's all cold. Look at my nipples.
Board here for all A, B, and C gates.
Yeah, I'm bored all the time. I got ADD. Like my mom's like, take this Ritalin. I'm all no. And then I did, and I was like, wah.
Hello, and welcome to Denver International Airport.
It's all big. It looks like a circus in here. Like, is that like canvas? Is this like a real circus or what?
This is the terminal.
Yeah, that's where my mom died. It was real sad.
Please exit the train.
Don't step on my mom, though. Hey. They're for sure going to pick us.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, they're definitely picking us.
It sounds good.
We have that Denver feel.
We do. We are Denver. You're a native, and I've been here since I was four.
I know.
Like, isn't that cool? They should be applauding Denver talent that actually has been here.
When Kathy was little, she grew up in New York, and so she came here at four. So when she got here, she was like, hey, what's going on here? What's that? This is a cowboy town. Y'all have horses? What's going on?
I was shaking down the paperboy.
Yeah, she's like, where's the candy store? What's going on?
Actually, that's the reason why my parents moved us out here.
Because they didn't want you to talk like that?
No. My mom, because my dad was working out at JFK. And at the airport.
Okay.
And so she said that one day the paper boy started totally like trying to shake her down for more money that she didn't owe.
Are you serious?
And she was like, I am not raising my children in an environment where even the paper boy is trying to shake you down.
You don't want something to happen to your car, right?
Right, exactly.
You better pay the bill.
My mom was like, so then the transfer came up for Denver. My dad was like, we're going to Denver.
That's
so
awesome.
It was Denver or Atlanta, so I'm glad they chose Denver. Although
you would have been real happy in Atlanta. And we know why.
I would have loved
You and Tyler could have been friends, Kathy. We could have picked your brothers together. I'd have shared a tip with you, but just a tip, not the whole shaft.
Okay, I'll take that.
Just a tip.
Yeah, because you guys always try to say that, but it never lasts.
And then when we go to barbecue joint, I only get the rib tips.
And now.
Hey.
It's time for.
All out on three. One, two, three.
All out. One, two, three.
Larry, you look very odd sports.
I was watching a sports show,
yeah,
a local sports show, and they had like a Bronco that's featured on it, you know?
Okay.
And so he's like with the sports reporter,
yeah,
and it's a weekly show or
the
whatever.
The Bronco
huddle.
Yeah.
Sure. I guess. So the thing is, I felt so sorry for the guy that signed up for that show because, you know, like when
Emmanuel
you sign.
I was going to say it's Emmanuel Sanders.
Sure.
Okay.
I like him. But what's funny is, like, you know, when he signed up, you know, he thought the show would be like, oh, you did great, and you guys won again, and you're champs, and this is great. But, you know, nobody anticipates a terrible season. So
right.
This is, like, the fourth show he's had to be like, well, I didn't see my career going here this way, but it's never going to happen again. I'm after this season, you know, I'm never going to let this happen again.
Okay.
So he's
saying it's something that can't be fixed.
Well, yeah, even if the Broncos telling, well, and plus he's like all looking at next year.
Right.
So he even knows that the season's toast or whatever. So since this is Larry LeBrand Sports and we already know the Broncos are done,
right,
we're going to talk about the Avengers trailer.
Yeah. Oh my God, have you seen the Avengers trailer?
Oh my everybody? God, it was so sick.
Like, all of a sudden, I saw it so fast, and at the end, I was like, oh, is that Black Panther?
Yes,
sure
of course.
Enough, it was.
Of course.
Of course I saw Black Panther.
Yeah, he's from Atlanta.
Man, I'm so excited to see the Black Panther movie.
And it, but well, the
all whole, my favorite actors are in that.
Right. But this Avengers trailer was kind of bittersweet because you're super excited that they're all back, but then you know this is the last one, so you could even see that in the trailer a little bit. Like
they're passing the torch.
Exactly.
Right.
They're going to give it to some young actors or something.
Right, like they have so many other
franchises.
Yeah, 20 years more that they could go with other Avengers.
Right, for sure. But like, if they stayed Avengers, eventually Thor would be like, my back!
Right, totally.
Right, and the Hulk's like laying in a big river of like, you know,
exactly,
cool his lower back.
Right, and as much as I hate to say it, Black Widow, you know, things, gravity takes over eventually when you get older. Not going to fit in that cat suit anymore.
Exactly. Is Black Panther... it's already been out, or no, it hasn't
no,
been out.
It doesn't come out. I think February is when it's coming out.
Yeah, that looks pretty sick.
It looks awesome. And the Michonne from The Walking Dead, she's like one of my favorite characters.
Uh-huh.
That actress is in Black Panther. Like, I'm just very excited for it.
Yeah, that's
the storyline, it's awesome.
But what about the Avs or the Nuggets or any of that?
Oh, yeah, we're still on Larry Liberian Sports.
Okay, now we're going to talk about... the DC comic movie Justice League, because there were some people that were like being indifferent about it, and I was like,
right,
man, that was a solid movie, you know. Yeah,
totally.
Although I kind of went in with lowered expectations, and you have to just give the fact that there's going to be some CGI that's meh.
Right.
And
Guardians of the Galaxy are in the end of the trailer for Avengers,
I know,
right?
And he's all, who are you?
It took me a second because I was like, did something just happen to the tape? And why are we with Guardians? And
yeah, they're all Marvel.
They're all together.
Exactly.
It's going to be insane. I can't wait.
And that's Larry Ulibarri on sports.
Was it?
And now?
Invasive, violating, and just disgusting.
It's Celebrity Trash and Bash.
With Larry, Kathy, and Wiggins.
It's really disappointing. They're just looking for the wrong photo.
Here's Kathie J.
This Trash and Bash is brought to you by the Savoya Law Firm. Matt Lauer. Keeps coming out, everybody. Oh, that's the wrong thing to say.
He seems so nice.
Doesn't he?
And the thing is, it's like, he just, you know, when you hear the details of some of the stuff he did,
mm-hmm,
it does not match his persona at all.
Right. But the people who did the research or the expose,
uh-huh,
for Variety Magazine,
uh-huh,
they say that when they talk to coworkers, past and present, they kind of all knew about it. And there's a Matt Lauer we see on TV, and then there's a Matt Lauer behind the scenes.
Huh.
And this Matt Lauer knew his power. And
this Matt Lauer knew his power. My thing is, it's such a bold move to just take your junk out. Like, that's like, that's that shock factor that they're after. You know,
yeah,
they want the woman to be like, bah!
I don't know. Or did he just want to get some infidelity going?
No, but what I'm saying is, it's like most women we've determined, they barely like looking at junk.
Yeah.
So it's like,
who would want to?
Well, I'm
totally
me. But okay. Like, you never get what you ask for, right?
No, yeah, never do.
But yeah, I just think that there's some women that like they just needed to see that like horror looked on their face. You know,
it's a power trip thing. It's not even a horror. It's like being like, you're a victim. I get to do this. I don't know.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing. I think that Harvey Weinstein and Brett Ratner and some of the other stories we've heard, Louis C.K., it was something of the power over your horrified look, you're trapped here and you're going to watch me do this. Matt Lauer, I think, was attempts to actually hook up and they went wrong.
Those are all attempts to hook up. All of them, really.
Right, but let me just... So in the Winter Olympic Games in 2014, that's when a female colleague accused him of inappropriate sexual conduct. It continued in the workplace after the games, and they came back.
So it was an intern.
Mm-hmm. That, no, no, no. Oh. Yeah, that was an intern.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, you think, you know, I'm away for the Olympics. My wife's not here.
Right.
This
here
intern's
we are.
Flirting with me.
Totally.
Right.
She's cute. She's young.
Well, and then let's, like, we talked about this earlier. You know, this is the intern who had an issue or whatever. Think of the four interns that were like, fine.
Right, exactly. Because he took a lot of trips with NBC.
Right.
There's three ladies so far. The one that went to NBC HR Monday night, her story was so compelling and had so much evidence that that's what caused them to say, okay, rumors are done.
Right, she's all, and then he took it out.
They're we're like, firing
okay,
you.
Hold on.
Well, another girl did say that Matt Lauer has a way to lock his office door from his desk.
Whoa.
And he would hit that button. So she went in there, he hit the button, and then dropped his pants and expected her to do that to him. And she said no, and he reprimanded her for it.
So you're a bad, bad victim.
And she got out of there, thank God. That was way back in 2001.
Yeah, that's going to be, like, there's so many, like,
bad.
Yeah, like, and then, like, some are past the statute and all that. And, so.
And I really liked what Savannah Guthrie said yesterday when she made the announcement. She said, we're grappling to deal with somebody that we know and love that is now being accused of doing such just dastardly deeds, you know? It's like, how do you deal with, I love you, I've been your friend for 30 years. What the hell did you do?
I know, but is there a difference, in your opinion, versus, like you say, Matt Lauer's like, hey, look at my stuff. Is this going to happen? Versus, I'm going to force myself on
you. No, absolutely.
Right. So there is a difference. Like, he was looking for consensual, or
well,
was he,
you know, but then forcing yourself on the girl is kind of the same as mentally forcing yourself saying, I'll take your job.
Right, right, right.
You know, like, that's just as bad of a position to be put in. And you will, and you, and some girls do put out because they don't want to lose their job.
Right, that's what I do.
You put out to who?
Us. We own this company.
Right,
I put out to us.
Yourself?
You put out
to myself.
Yeah, you lock yourself in a room with a button.
Exactly.
Great, now I can't go in the bathroom after Wiggins because he drops a bomb every time. Now I can't go in there after Larry because he's in there
making himself uncomfortable.
Matt Lauer did release a statement. He broke his silence. He says that some, even though some of what has been reported is untrue or mischaracterized, there is enough truth in the stories to make me feel embarrassed and ashamed. He's 59 years old. Matt Lauer went on to say, there are no words to express my sorrow and regret for the pain I've caused others by words and action. To the people I've hurt, I am truly sorry. As I'm writing this, I realize the depth of the damage and disappointment that I've left behind at home and at NBC.
The damage is done, so I guess he'll be leaving.
He said, repairing the damage is going to take a lot of time and soul searching, and I'm committed to beginning the effort. It's now my full-time job.
He's all, until I get a full-time job.
Exactly, right?
Because some of these guys will make their way back in if it wasn't like,
I don't
they
know.
Weren't Cosby.
The Harassers News Network. Bill O'Reilly and Matt Lauer, produced by Harvey Weinstein.
Number one rated. Yeah. Everybody watches.
There you go.
Right. Yeah. Awkward.
Yeah. Beyonce, Bey, and Jay, they made some music together, everybody.
Yeah, we know. They have three kids.
Right.
That you mean music.
Right. Right, right. In a new interview with the New York Times, Jay-Z says it happened. We were using our art almost like a therapy session, and we started making music together. Then the music she was making at the time was further along, so
she's all, quit peeing on the toilet bowl. Quit peeing on the toilet bowl. We have daughters, toilet bowl. He's all, okay, I get it.
What would he say to her?
Nothing, because he's the one that cheated.
Exactly.
He's the idiot.
What do you say to Beyonce? You can't. Also,
your sister's ugly. Oh, he raps.
Jay-Z also talked about his complicated relationship with Kanye. He said there's tension right now, but they're always going to be good. He said he talked to Kanye the other day just to tell him he's my brother. He said he loves Kanye. He says hopefully when we're 89 years old, we look at this 6 months or whatever time this is going to take, and we're going to laugh at it.
That's awesome, that statement right there, because he's like, he's going to have to wait till we're that old to be friends. So good luck having a healthy, long life.
And
see you at the care facility.
And Jay-Z admitted to infidelity.
Yeah, I know. It's like,
how?
Well, he admitted by getting his ass kicked by Solange in the elevator.
Well, right, right, right.
Wait, if he hadn't cheated, he would have hit her back.
No.
You know what I mean? Knows.
He did hit a girl once. That's something that follows him. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Well, you know, or he mushed her face, something, but whatever. It wasn't
that's
good.
That's jacked up.
Okay, so Jay-Z said he discussed psychotherapy, and that's when he made his admission of infidelity. Jay-Z
These
said,
are my confessions.
He talked about being emotionally scarred from being growing up in poverty in Brooklyn. He said, you have to survive. You have to go into survival mode. And when you go into survival mode, you know what happens? You shut down all your emotions. So even with women, you're going to shut down emotionally so you can't connect. In my case, like it's deep. And then all the things happen from there. Infidelity.
He's all lemonade.
Right.
Right.
The interviewer didn't push it, which I'm sad about.
Right, because he was starting to ball up his fist.
But we do know, you know, there's the Sorry track from Beyonce. And then Jay-Z's 444 alluded to cheating in there when he says, I apologize, often womanize. Took my child to be born, see through a woman's eyes. Took for these natural twins to believe in miracles. Took me too long for this song, I don't deserve you. That
that's
says you
pretty
cheated.
Good, though.
That says you cheated. But
well,
wow, he's such a lyricist. I love him.
If she did put your stuff in a box to the left, it would be a huge box.
Yeah, right?
Right, because there'd be like tons of stuff.
Here's
in
the
it.
Keys to the mansion.
Helicopter,
all your stuff is
Lamborghini, staff.
He also said that the rap game is a young man's game.
He's on my back.
He said he's in the sunset of his recording career.
Okay.
You know, when you got all that money.
Why wouldn't you?
Yeah, like, he said sure. That rap in particular is a young man's sport. I'll move out of the white hot space. Rap is about the gift discovery.
It is.
Kind of like Eminem. Like when he got sober and stuff, it was like, what are you going to rap about? You know, like you're not struggling.
Right.
So I get that. It's a young man's game. I get it.
It's a mumbler's rap game now. With auto-tune.
There is a lot of that. There is a lot of that. Yeah. And that's all. That's your, I think we went long enough.
I actually have a song that I wanted to play because we were talking about music and I found, because I was looking for Jay-Z audio.
Yeah.
It's a little sample from NERD and Future. Hold on.
Oh, yeah.
And Jay-Z's on the song.
It's their it's off the upcoming album, No One Ever Really Dies.
Yep.
December 15th. Everything cool is dropping December 15th. Other guests on the album with Nerd are MIA, Ed Sheeran, Andre 3000, Gucci Mane, Wale, and Kendrick Lamar.
I put my hands up.
No, this is called 1000.
With Future.
1000.
To your point, Larry.
Jay-Z's like, I'm going home.
Yeah, because it does have the auto-tune and he's mumbling.
Right.
That's just what you said.
Okay, let down. Maybe someone likes that.
I haven't even got to the hook.
I didn't even get to the hook yet.
No, we'll listen to it later.
Well, that's what they put in. That was all they put in at the song. So that's probably was the
that
hook.
Was, that might,
probably
the hook.
Might have been the hook. A Celebrity Trash and Brash brought to you by Mike Sawoya.
Larry and Kathie present.
Turn it up.
Turn it up.
Okay, yes, I do.
Blazin' Hit Radio.
303-728-3420. You can send us a shout out from the phone, a text from the phone, all within the app, or call us. And we've been getting some of these in there. Larry, someone actually, shout out to Good Morning from Seattle. I love you guys. I've been listening to you for the last 12 years, including the 6 years I've been in Washington.
Yeah.
So happy y'all are back. And there's a picture of
Seattle. Oh my
Seattle.
God. That's a cool picture. Is that a picture really that she took, or is that something that's been doctored? That looks amazing.
I was thinking she went to Google, but when you look at the filter, it looks like she actually took that. And
that
that's
is
the filter.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's like a picture of Seattle downtown with a bunch of clouds. Beautiful.
This one says, my wake and bake with some Yuliberry.
Oh, nice.
Love you guys. From the Green Solution, you can get your own strain there,
yes,
Larry.
That's my strain, and a lot of people are loving it. When you go in, sometimes it's sold out, but you can go to different Green Solutions, and they'll usually have it.
That's a high-tech bong piece of glass. That's cool looking.
A little bubbler, a little bubbly.
I like it.
A little bubbly.
And we also were talking about, we love seeing where you guys take us throughout the day while you're listening to us in the city.
Except the crapper.
We had somebody in there cleaning, but they took
the
a picture.
Crapper?
But we haven't had them on. And this isn't an invitation for someone out there to do that.
Send your picture of you on the toilet.
Yeah.
This guy just sent a picture of his construction hat. He's got the Green Solution sticker representing on it with the Broncos and other stickers.
We totally love and respect that.
Mm-hmm.
But if he, you know, drops a hammer on somebody's head, they're going to be like, drug test that guy.
That's what I was thinking. I was like, well, it's kind of an open season
he owns the business because there's a Bronco logo on there, too. So.
That's awesome.
But he's always representing is what he says, and we love you. Thank you for laughing with us.
There was a guy in here, too, that took a selfie when he delivers
uniforms. this all day. People.
Yeah, so.
Man, he's the perfect guy to know before you hold up a bank.
Like, I'm going to need five.
Right,
I'm going to need
two cleaning ladies, and then I need two cop and two kitchen workers.
Exactly.
And then we do the Ocean's 11 thing, you know? Yeah. Keep that guy's number.
Right, exactly. Okay. We know him. He's been with us a while.
Oh, nice.
We know him. But that's cool that he's got his earbuds in listening.
That's
he
dope.
Says it helps to go by faster through
oh,
the day.
Oh, cool.
Because now he can listen to us all day. So that's pretty awesome.
Yay. Yes.
All right. Good. No crapper pictures.
Yeah.
Be sure to come see what we're like when we're drunk. That's
we're
tonight.
Fun. At I the want you to know we're fun.
Alamo Draft House from 4 to 6. It's the Sloan's Lake location. And we're pretty lucky because all of us tipsy are very loving.
Yes.
You know what I mean? No, right. Nobody gets aggressive or sad
right.
or crying.
Except for the last happy hour where I couldn't pull myself
oh, that
out
was
of the
you.
Chair. One
yeah.
more time, Kelsey, if you're out there, please come
Wait,
back
what
tonight.
Happened?
I'll be a better drunk.
Kathy showed up to happy hour already with a couple shots in her.
Uh-huh.
So she once she had a couple drinks, she was not going anywhere.
No, no.
And so she found a quiet corner
I did.
A listener as a blanket.
Kelsey.
And she's like, please sit with me. And Kelsey's like, hell yeah, I'll sit with you. And then Kathy ate and then sobered up.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah, that's how it went down. It was wow. a good time.
A little too much YOLO rum,
I can't
huh?
wait for today.
Yeah, yeah.
Man, I tell you what, you start drinking that YOLO rum, and before you know it, it's like, it's gone because it's so smooth and you just don't, it's just delicious. So much so, yesterday, you know we have a bunch of alcohol delivered a lot of times to the station.
Uh-huh. People are,
so yesterday, there was some tequila, and it was supposed to be like $90 a shot.
Whoa.
Okay, and you know I love tequila, so I was like, let's
yes.
try it.
We know that Kathy loves tequila because she stole a bottle of it at Wiggins reception.
Oh my gosh.
I yeah. don't know what you're talking
ma'am,
about.
Ma'am, could you give that back, please?
Come back. Come
I was
back.
Like, oh,
come
somebody handed it back. To me. Here you go, take it.
But it's all inclusive. Why do you have the bottle?
I wanted to tell him that. Go get another
right,
bottle. You
exactly.
guys are the mariachi band. Go get another bottle. Dang it. So then we all did this shot, right? And we all looked at each other and we were like, man, I don't think it's worth $90.
Right, then, that should taste like water.
And then Chris Phelan, our, you know, the executive producer, he goes, I'll tell you what, it's not as good as that YOLO rum.
Mm.
And I was like, thank you, Chris. And then Mary was like, yeah, the gold, I hide that when people come over because I don't want them to use it.
That's our new thing, you know, the Blazin' Hit Radio drink that we're serving tonight.
Yeah.
It's like they took some... I don't know what kind of juices, but they paired it with the YOLO Silver, and then they muddle a jalapeno in there.
Yum. Mm-hmm.
And it's kind of a drink that's not subtle on the heat, but is awesome.
Again, mm-hmm. not doing it tonight with the jalapenos.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. One jalapeno.
Right, yeah. right. Get the Kathy Blazin' Hit radio drink version.
Well, you know what's awesome is we always go to Florida.
Yeah.
We just got the world's third largest distributor in all of Florida.
Congratulations.
And so we're, well, to you too, you're
yeah,
part
right.
of that. And
it's
so
cool.
we're actually going to be able, next time we go out there, man, maybe you guys get in Universal, Disney, drink some YOLO.
Yeah, yeah, that was our next, eventually our next thing that we wanted to do is take a bunch of you out with us somewhere like we used to do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so we want to go have a little getaway with you.
Oh,
and
yeah.
So, yeah, yeah, we're going to start small.
Right.
So we're just going to go to Fort Lupton.
Uh-huh.
And then with 12 winners.
Okay.
And then we're going to branch
Fort Lupton?
Out. I don't know.
Okay.
We're going to branch out from there. We're going to go to Blackhawk. And then eventually we'll make it all the way to Florida, Orlando.
Okay.
We're going the wrong way if we're heading to Blackhawk
oh,
from
yeah.
Fort Morgan.
I don't know. Just try to spread
Lupton.
The wealth.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, so speaking of places around Denver, what was the name of the street? Did you guys ever grow up on a weird named street?
Yeah.
I'm on one now.
What do you want?
Urivan.
No, Urivan.
Urivan.
And I don't know. And so people don't know. I don't know if it's Urivan. I just don't know.
I'm a van.
Yeah,
you're a van.
We're all vans.
Like
yeah.
Urivan.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So now everyone's going to come to my house.
Is it Irvine?
No.
Okay.
That's what's weird about it. U-R-A-V-A.
Yeah, that would be Urivan.
Urivan.
Urivana.
I'm a Jesus.
Now I don't know where
you don't even know where you live.
So I'm all trying to trick people. I'm all, don't come to my house.
I grew up on 115th. There was no street name. It was
yeah,
115th.
I'm 98th in Sheridan.
Okay. No, you the cul-de-sac, there wasn't a name there?
No. It's literally 98th, and you just go right, and it's that's 98th.
I know, but you have a bunch of houses in there. There's a street name.
I swear to God, my address is... I can't get my address. Everybody
no,
go
can.
To my mom's house.
Yeah, but, okay.
After they go to my house,
anyways,
then we're all the time
right.
to go to Larry's.
The reason why I'm asking is, everybody out there, if you are looking for a house, okay, find houses that are on streets with names that are kind of inappropriate. Because those houses... are 20% below market value, all because of the street name.
You mean because people think of it like, I'm not going to live on Whore Avenue?
Exactly.
Wow.
Something embarrassing, those names will sell for less money.
It's like just off Taint Boulevard.
Well, they said streets like Wiener Cutoff Road in Wiener, Arkansas.
Balzac. It's like I live in a Balzac, a cul-de-sac.
There is a butt road spelt B-U-T-T in right. Fort Wayne, Indiana.
It's a dirt road.
There it is.
Gets muddy.
Okay. There's a Katie Crotch Road.
That's where Tom Cruise lived for a little bit. Now Jamie Foxx resides there.
Okay, in Maine, and those are all real. So, you know, I mean, like Crotch Alley, I don't know. Like,
yes, Kathy's going to be driving around looking for Donger Lane.
Students in Australia analyzed 47 years, so that's a long time, of property records, found that houses on embarrassing streets sell for an average of 20% below the market value.
I live on Vagina Circle.
So, they also said that 33% of people say they absolutely would not live on a street with a sexual name.
You mean Areola Way?
Yeah. Exactly.
If you're looking for a house, then right, that's start, and you're trying to be cheap, there you go.
Look through it and go, you'll find a great house, but not the best.
Yeah, you're
going
to go past
name.
Taint Boulevard to Sphincter
right.
Road
right.
and go right.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, right? Nobody wants that. You don't want a daughter that grew up on
Pube Lane.
Right. That too, right.
What street did you grow up on?
You know what? There was a street in my hometown, and it was Hooker Street.
All right.
But we always called it Hooker Alley because that's where all the
hookers were. That's funny. When we took my grandpa, he had to go to rehab for drinking.
Yes.
And the rehab place he was staying on was on High Street.
Like,
how
this
ironic.
Is horrible.
Yeah. Right.
You can't have a rehab facility on High Street.
That's how they got him in there, though. Right. Like, come on, we're going to take you to High Street.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
going to be great.
You're going to have a great time. You're going to like be there for like 30 days and not even remember it.
We had to go with him, you know, to
support.
Like, yeah, and yeah. like you have to see what's happened with Grandpa. And he has to show you and tell you all this stuff. And inside of that place, they have them sit at a bar
uh-huh.
with mirror behind it, so they have to watch themselves drink their medicine.
Whoa.
So like, in other words, they get you, part of the psyche is like, now you're in this bar, this is a negative, you know what I mean? Like, so it's set up like a real bar.
Is negative.
Right.
So, okay,
it's kind of weird.
So do you go by yourself, or do they go with their other patients and they're all sitting at the bar together?
No, I think it's like that's where you go to take your medicine.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And then so they want you to have an appearance of a bar, to look at yourself in the mirror, because most bars have a mirror on the other
side. Yeah, right, right, right. So it's kind of like,
look what you did. Look what you made us do. Look what you made us do.
They'd have to do it solo, because if there were anybody else in there, I could honestly start feeling like it was a bar.
Right, no, for sure. Like, can you pass the peanuts?
Yeah, exactly. Well,
like, you guys want to play pool?
I can still have a good time without the alcohol.
Right.
I thought that's what the idea was when you said the medicine, but I was thinking that they wanted you to be in that scenario, not drinking.
Yeah.
So that you are
used
to that. Oh, okay.
It was just more of a, it wasn't like a big room. It was just like one room, but it was set up to look like a bar.
Right. I got that.
Okay.
Okay. And did it work though? Did your grandpa become sober?
Totally.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it totally worked.
That's really good. That's something hard to kick.
Or maybe he was just hiding the YOLO like Kathy.
Yeah, right. Oh, yeah. Exactly. You just don't put it out when guests are coming.
Yeah.
Larry and Kathy's Blazin' Hit Radio.
More music, less commercials.
Blazin' Hit Radio, Larry Ulibrary, Kathy J and Wiggins.
You can always reach us on the text line. You can call and give us a shout out through your app. The text line's 303-728-3420. This one says, my daughter got in the car after school yesterday and asked, why are Larry and Kathy not on? Because, you know, she just associates us with the radio.
Right.
You guys make our mornings every morning when we're getting ready for school. So it was so cool when I could turn you on in the afternoon and listen again.
Yay.
She couldn't believe it. So glad you guys are back and we can listen whenever we want.
Yay. Blazin' Hit Radio.
That's awesome. Yes. Let's see. And someone just says, good morning, y'all. Thanks for the great laughs and always representing. We love
Yay.
It. Yes. All right, this one is for you, Wiggins.
Okay.
You have to throw out your underwear every year, sir.
You know what? It's funny that you say that, because I have boxers that are so old that I have like farted holes through them.
Shut up!
And so,
shut up!
But
oh
I
my
won't.
God, that's disgusting.
But I won't
let them go.
Get rid of them.
Why?
You know why?
But I won't,
why?
Because now they're lingerie. You know what I mean?
No, no.
Before they were underwear. Now they have holes in them.
No, no.
It's like lingerie.
Okay, this is the break glass in case of emergencies. So thank God for my wife who puts up with my laundry and does it. But if she flies away. So if she's gone and I run out of stuff.
He's all, where's my old underwear? She didn't get these ones.
It's just you and me, friend.
Right. <No.
laughs> We're barely hanging on together.
He's all, I don't even have to pull the pants down because there's a hole in the front.
You guys will wear your underwear until they literally disintegrate off of your body.
No. The thing is, you have to, ask for that for Christmas, because now I'm all set on underwear, because the last couple of Christmases I was like, I just want underwear. And that's a really easy thing for people to give, Chris knows my brand.
Right, right. And if it's just what somebody's buying for you, they can spend a little bit more on them so you can have nice underwear.
Exactly.
Right. But everyone out there, throw out your underwear every year or it could become a huge health risk.
Every year, that's ridiculous, because the underwear should be good for at least, 5 years?
Let me tell you
six.
Why. Even though you wash them, wear after wear, old underwear can develop a... yep, exactly. A buildup of bacteria even as bad as E. coli. That can lead to you getting infections for guys and girls, it says, Larry. Guys
E. coli.
And, and nobody wants that. So not everybody is even washing those regularly. 18% of men, 10% of women wear underwear multiple times before washing them. How could you do
that? That's gross. Okay, but there's
Wiggins was silent just now. You've worn underwear more than one wear.
One wear? No.
So every day you put on a clean pair?
Not that I'm married. And it's done.
Okay, so that's clean. Why
no, I never was that way. I didn't like that because it was like it still had a smell to it. So you're not gonna do that.
There's a button on it though that like each washing machine now has like a sanitize button that's supposed to use really hot water.
Oh.
So you fancy, huh? No, I didn't know.
I don't even know. The study didn't say there are new washing machines sanitized.
Ours isn't that new.
Like a blue light comes on.
No,
like
there's just a button that says sanitized, and it's like super hot water, and that's one of the cycles. It's our washing machines aren't like brand new. They're like 10 years old.
Oh,
okay. I've never seen a sanitized button.
Okay. Sorry.
But then I just turn it on to my biggest concern is hot and cold. Like if you put in hot water, it shrinks or something like that. I don't even know what does what. That's my concern.
Well, and if you have like nice colored underwear, like where it's like it might suck if you wash it unsanitized because then they are going to like shrink or.
Okay. What colors are your underwear that you need to make sure that they stay?
I have all colored underwear.
Usually it's just grays, reds, blacks, blues.
Mine are plaid.
What do you
want? I have all designs, different designs, plaid, some are green, some are purple, some are all colors.
Are you boxers or boxer briefs?
Boxer briefs.
Wiggins?
Boxers.
Boxers. Okay. All right. Producer Bolte? Boxers.
I feel harassed.
You should be.
I feel
harassed.
Like, why? Because Kathy's asking about our underwear.
Oh.
Matt Lauer.
Yeah. Wait, y'all. I do have to find that clip
because
he did
underwear?
Talk about underwear.
They did a skit a couple years ago where he drops his pants to show the other three female anchors his cool boxers.
Okay.
I think that's what
butt,
this is.
His butt is facing the camera.
Okay.
But you can definitely see his suit jacket, his pants have dropped, his boxers are hanging there, and the women are all like, they're laughing and joking.
Okay.
Heads up, looking at the ceiling kind of
thing.
Right,
like trying to look away.
But it's like, this, now that you go back and look at him, it doesn't look as innocent as it was back when they did it.
Right.
This was a skit, it says, but let's see this.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lauer.
That's okay. I gotta repress my designer slacks. Alex!
I'm here, Matt!
Alright, 5 minutes tops. I gotta look as good as that numbnuts Regis Philbin.
You got it, Matt.
I sure do.
Drink
it in, ladies.
Again, Matt? Really?
He's in his underwear there.
It's the first time this week. Did your mommy give you those?
Oh, wow.
Stop it, you're making me lactate.
Yeah, get it while it lasts.
Ew. Jesus. Get it while it lasts. Drink it in, ladies.
Yeah. He's all, I'm going to lock you in with this button in my office.
See, and that seems really, cute and innocent.
Right, right. And that's
the
like,
ladies laugh, but now you look back and go, he told him to drink it in.
Hit the button, let me out of the room.
Right? Like you start pounding on the glass wall, please.
No, you know what? I'm like, please not the weather guy. Please not him too.
Roker?
Yeah. We don't want to know that he was doing stuff too. Please not him.
What's happening in your neck of the woods?
Right.
Because I know what's happening in mine. Yes. Yeah, everything has a new meaning now
exactly.
That we know.
We should just all stay home and order our groceries from
home.
Wow. Larry and Kathy J's Blazin' Hit Radio.
Live from a mile high. And now worldwide.
Kathy, you're going to see Chris Parenti today when you do the Everyday Show at Fox 31.
Yeah, she's leaving here in a few minutes.
Right, so will you ask him if he can come over to my house tonight to record our new gay Christmas song?
Yes, yes, yes. I forgot to ask him yesterday.
Okay. Oh, you really are doing one.
Yeah, yes. It's going to be called A Few of Our Favorite Queens.
Right, because last year was, it's the most wonderful time to be queer. I can't say that word.
Kathy doesn't think she can say queer.
I can't say the word, even though I'm a beard, even though I'm a hack.
No, but queer, queer was actually not a slam, you know what I mean? Queer just could be like, well, that tree's out of place, that's queer. You know what I mean?
Yeah, see, I never heard that term.
Okay. Well, it's not really one of our top 10 that we're offended by.
Right. Didn't your mother-in-law, God rest her soul, didn't she try to have an explanation for a racial or a gay slur?
Yeah, it was...
Do you remember what it was?
Damn it, yeah, because she was talking about some actor, and she was like, oh, we knew he was a fruitcake.
Right.
And then and Chris goes, what, Mom? She's like, what? And you can tell he was a fruitcake. He's like, Mom, you really can't say that. Especially if you have a gay son.
And then she started to justify it.
No, back in the day, a fruitcake meant that you were just fruity.
Right.
And he's like, that means gay. Yeah. Right. I miss those arguments.
Nita.
Oh, man.
Right? You never thought you'd say that.
Exactly. But, I mean, she always kept you on your toes, and she's just a sweet, traditional kind of lady. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I'm so sad that she passed away. I mean, like, She knew, though, that how much she meant to me. Like, she was the first person in my life to say, you're awesome. I believe in you, and I love what you're doing, and you be you, and you keep, you know, reaching for the stars. Like, she was the first, like, real support from a parent kind of figure that I got.
Thanks a lot, Nita. That's why Kathy's such a diva now. Yeah. She says, she's right. I am a star.
Because she helped me with self-esteem when I was 16.
That was awesome. No.
It was. She was like, but she was the first dose of that because she was that. Mm-hmm. She was always like wanting to know what you were doing and then giving you your little cheerleader speech about go for it. That's who you are.
Right.
Yeah.
My relationship hurt with her a little different. Most of our relationship, I was like, please don't feed my dog people food.
Yeah, that was that.
She'd be like, I'm going to do it anyway.
She always fed Yoshi people food. And people will get kicked out of Larry's house for feeding Yoshi people food.
That was back in the day. I'm a little more lenient, but I mean.
You had to bend with your mother-in-law and it drove you crazy.
Like, the thing is, if she really wanted to, like, I would have preferred her, like, here, feed him, like, something that's not pizza.
Yeah, right. You know what I mean? Like, or a potato chip.
Or a chicken
full
wing.
Full of saturated fat.
Right.
But before Kathy gets out of here to go to the Everyday Show with Chris Parenti, yes. And I'm looking forward to that song, Larry, we got to tell you about the Christmas Wish. We're accepting letters now at ChristmasWish@BlazinHitRadio.com.
Right. Let us know about somebody that you know who is like not in the best situation for the holiday season and might need some help.
And I'd like to say thank you to the Green Solution for helping us make this possible.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. So definitely, you know, mention in the letter your contact information, their contact information, and, you know, make it about two paragraphs and tell us about some kids that might not be getting toys.
Yep. And now let's go back to a classic. Most wonderful time to be
queer. It's the most wonderful time to be queer.
Ding dong. Ding dong.
With gay marriage passing and male twerk dancing, everyone please cheer. It's the most wonderful time to be queer.
It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings and trips to the mall. It's the gayest season of all.
There'll be drinks at the compound, then we're off to Boys Town and Lanny's Clock Tower show.
There'll be scary stories and big holes of glory and hopefully lots of snow.
It's the most wonderful time to be queer. There'll be much mistletoeing, but no camel towing. Grinder says you're near. It's the most wonderful time to be queer.
NFL player, a Navy SEAL slayer, and that's just to start. We've got Wentworth Miller, Jim Parsons, and Sam Smith ruling the charts. It's the most wonderful time to be queer. With the gay marriage passing and male twerk dancing, everyone please cheer. It's the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time.